starting. We'll test how good your internet is now. It's getting pretty much straight away.
Yeah, it's decent now.
Yeah, it is.
Get on with Gary Porn on it.
That's good stuff. Good stuff.
Right, oh, you on?
Yeah.
Are you streaming?
Yeah. The first couple of minutes is just me pissing about while people connect, because it don't tell people we're streaming straight away.
Yeah, it takes a while, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
We should have some like lift music on in the background.
Oh no, yeah. Well, when I was doing the Spectrum Next games and stuff, I keep it just sat right, facing the screen. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, we've got a drummer, and we should have just some drums, really.
Cheers, man. Thank you. So at least you could be like plugging yourselves. So anyway, yeah, a couple of people find it now. Anyway, so how's it going, guys? Welcome to another Yam Yam Retro Gaming stream. We're here today with a much bigger selection of Yam Yams joining the party.
He's a brummie.
Oh, see. See, for those of you who don't know, what's the difference?
Brummies are guns.
Yeah, Brummies are wild. Brummies have got
this... tone, you're getting outranked here.
Brummies got a really strange accent. They all sound like them underwater, I think. So, it's one night, blah, 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 blah.
Tommy's like a rare breed, though, because he's a decent Brummie.
He's all right, eh?
Yeah.
He's not a prize cow. He's not a rare breed.
He fucking is.
I'm premium cut, mate.
Fucking look at the udders on that.
So anyway, today's stream, guys, we're all here together because we're doing some test filming for some other things and we're trying a few things out, and it's a rare opportunity for a few of us to get together because we're all just so busy.
I'm not.
Well, alright, he's not, but everybody else is so busy. So so today we've got in the room two, definitely. Are you a fanboy?
Yeah, not as big as these guys though.
You're more micros,
aren't
you,
really? Yeah, I'm more
spectrums.
Yeah. Okay, then. So we've got two Sega fanboys, and we've got one man who
peripheral,
started like
peripheral, yeah.
So
he only likes the joint pads.
Yeah. So introduce yourselves properly, guys, just so everyone knows who you are. So everyone who knows this spaz in here. So what we've got at the end there.
Mike. Head in.
Tony. Hello.
Right. Okay. Nice introduction, guys. So anyway, yeah, that's Mike and Tony, and of course, all of you know Aaron from the Big Gob on all my other videos. You're not going to hear or see much of me because A, I'm losing my voice, and B, I don't appear on camera today. It's all about these boys. Now, the reason we've got together is because, like I say, we've got a couple of Sega fanboys in the room, and there's a couple of things here they don't often get opportunity to get hands-on with. Sega consoles, you know, most people now own them. You know, most people kind of back in the day were all about Nintendo or about Sega. And I catch it in the ribs a lot from these guys about being a Nintendo fanboy back in the day. I'm not anymore. And yet these call themselves Sega fanboys. And yet there's two systems here they probably have never played. And one that they've rarely played. So I've never seen,
let alone played.
And the Nintendo fanboy in the room is the one who actually owns all three of them and has brought them along. So we're going to be going over some of those and discussing what these guys think of them when they see them. So first up, we've got the Sega Megazord, as we've dubbed it, which is this bastard concoction of the Mega Drive, the Mega CD, and the 32X, topped off nicely there by the Everdrive, because I don't own any 32X games, I'm sorry to say. And we've tied up the wiring a bit with a nice three-way adapter so we don't blow any sockets. Along the front, we've got the Mega Drive X. Now, for those of you who don't know, the Mega Drive X is a system which is basically a clone console, but it's based on the Mega Drive 3 profile. And it's got a few neat little tricks which I will cover shortly, but I brought it to show these guys because those neat little tricks make it more playable than a regular Mega Drive in normal use. And finally over there we've got the Sega Nomad. Now this Gizit man here is trying to claim it, but it's not going to happen. This is one of my proud pickups here. This is the only official Sega produced handheld console. It's the only official Sega produced handheld 16-bit console, and it's basically a portable Mega Drive. Now we can take a look at this first, so you might as well go back and sit down with that.
All right.
So the Sega Nomad.
You've never played one, so go.
Yeah, I think actually.
I can tell it on.
You call it bitch.
That's what I call you.
You call him bitch. So, Sega Nomad. It's a 16-bit handheld console based on the Mega Drive. It was... Is it on?
No. You fucking bastard. Giz it here.
Now, you know what? I might not actually put the right... I might not put, like, decent batteries in. So, I'm going to dive over and grab some batteries.
No, it's working. Just Mike.
Yeah, it's just Mike.
Yeah.
Obviously, they're turning things on. That's my missus.
So you guys like your Mega Drive, yeah? You really like your Mega Drive. Have you ever come across a Nomad before? Have you ever got hands on with one?
Until I seen your stream, nope.
Not in real life. I mean, I've seen them, I knew of them. Never knew anybody that had one. And I started going to conventions I played in.
Yeah.
Punch the fucking wolf, you cunt.
So, Mike's getting into it already. Right, so the system itself, yeah? It came out around the same time as the Mega Drive 2 was released, so it shares similar specs with the Mega Drive 2. It's got a, I think it's a 3-inch screen on there.
Shall I get the camera on it?
No, I'll pan out with that in just a sec.
Okay.
It's got a 3-inch screen on here. It's got the standard 16-bit Mega Drive architecture, and it's got TV out, and it's got a port on the bottom. If you've played Mega Drive before, it's pretty standard fare. But, I mean, as a handheld console, I mean...
The screen's beautiful, yeah. But that's an aftermarket screen, isn't it?
It is indeed, yeah. We're going to come over now. So, no, you're all right, mate. You stay where you are. I'll work around you. So...
Fucking yes, mate.
Shape shift!
No to the wind! Alter Beast, very much a love it or hate it kind of game. I mean, what's your verdict? Do you love it or do you hate it?
I love it, but it's easier if you play two players. Yeah. Solid as one player.
Not a good game for me, but aesthetically, enjoying it, Alter Beast.
I think it's a tidy game, man. I mean, I had like a NES at the time, and like my mate got his Mega Drive, like I think it was the same year I got my NES.
Oh, if you'd have played this in, say, like 1990, and all you had was a NES, this would have been like another fucking world.
Oh, definitely. And like, I used to love these side. I mean, I know this is like single playing, but I like the whole side-scrolling brawler thing. You know, at the time in the arcades, things like Turtles and Simpsons are riding high. So co-op like beat 'em ups and stuff like that, I was a massive fan of. And this, you know, we hadn't had anything as good as this at home, so I was a big fan of it back in the day. Paul's just said, "Why is from your grave?"
Well, Mike, who's playing this. At the moment, he's having a tattoo next Friday, and do you want to describe what in the part? You're having a game.
Yeah, I'm having a full sleeve, full Sega sleeve. I'm gonna have when he changes, when you finally get all your power ups, and it's like it flashes between the man and the wolf or whatever character you change into. So I'm gonna have part wolf, part the man. Then I'm gonna have Rise from Your Grave.
But he's literally having as a tattoo, not Rise from Your Grave. You're having it written out as.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna
Rise
have
Rise from Your Grave.
Yeah, I'm gonna have that.
Perfect.
Oh, that's fun. So getting to grips with it then. Have you played Game Gear before, both of you?
Yeah, I've still got my Game Gear.
Still got one, yeah.
What do you think of that as a handheld?
The Game Gear is brilliant, but the screen's a bit wank. That's about all I can. And the battery life?
Yeah, you needed one of them big power packs that was like a fucking car battery.
What's the battery life like on this?
Well, that's the thing, see, like the Game Gear originally used like 6 batteries in 2 separate compartments. This uses 6 batteries as well. If you just want to hold it up, mate, you'll see on the back there, it uses this big kind of dutty, like ugly battery pack just kind of slabbed on the back there, which is kind of awkward, but makes it handy when you set it down because it literally stands up facing you. So it's quite cool. So Paul says he hated the Game Gear.
Really?
Just some Sega haters on already, look.
Which Paul?
Paul Cole.
Oh.
Don't know him, but...
How dare him.
Yeah,
fuck you. Okay, so holding this then, Mike, I mean, how does it stack up against the Game Gear in terms
it's
of...
It's a lot heavier.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot heavier. There's a lot more going on in there.
Yeah. But,
what about the D-pad and the buttons and stuff?
It's comfortable.
Well, before we went on camera, I was playing... Castlevania Bloodlines, and I thought it was perfect. I loved it. The buttons, the D-pad, absolutely bang on.
The D-pad's an interesting talking point, actually, because a lot of people said it was like a love-it-or-hate-it affair, but the people who do like it, who've played Mega Drive a lot, have said it's probably the, one of the best D-pads you can play Mega Drive games with.
It's up there with the six-button joypad D-pad.
Because it's kind of loose to fit to feel, a bit like the Game Gear one, but it's more comfortable on your thumbs. Which, when you actually look at it close up, it's got these weird kind of dimples on it. It looks strange, but it feels really good. I'll tell you what, playing fighting games with it, you can do fluid motion through the corners. I mean, it's nowhere near using like a Neo Geo Pocket kind of digital switch stick, but it's thumb stick, but it is like fluid around the corners. So
you're actually really good at this, Mike. You've played this a lot. It's very rare I'll manage to fight the boss on the first meet. I usually need another fucking power up.
Well, let's see if he gets the position right to get.
Yeah, you're gonna get clock kill.
Boom!
Not bad.
Fair play, mate.
So you got the spacing correct. You know what? Some people really struggle with that. And if you get hit, it really throws you off.
Sorry.
You can suck that if you want.
Easy reward.
Yeah. You can suck that if you want. Not a problem.
So if you'd have had access to one of these back in the day,
I'd got one.
Would you have got
one? Definitely. But there was about 200 quid, were there?
200. I think it was more than 200 quid. In fact, it would have cost more for one of these.
There was no way as a kid, having a Mega Drive bought for me on my birthday, there was no way I could look my mum and dad in the eye and say, can I have another Mega Drive that's smaller, plays exactly the same games but costs more? They'd go, fuck you on your bike.
Right, but you know what? It is genuinely a replacement for a Mega Drive.
You can connect it to the telly, can you?
Yep, it's got a... look at the top there. It's actually good that you've passed it out to Tanya there. There's a port on the top there. That is the same multi-out as the Mega Drive 2. So you can connect it to TV via composite.
Has it got the same sort of little niggles that the Mega Drive 2's got? There's all little sand issues and stuff.
You know what? In all honesty, I haven't actually hooked it up myself, so maybe we can might be able to do that in a bit actually, and just see how it fares hooked up. It's got the same pair adapter as the Game Gear there. You can see the slot is carved for British and American games. It is actually NTSC only. So, even though we're running a PAL game on it now, early Mega Drive games didn't have any kind of region protection, but you try and run, you know, Street Fighter 2, trying to think of a list of the games, Comic Zone, stuff like that, they won't run on there, and you'll get a copyright error when you try and... when you try and plug it in and try and play it, but at least then plugging in, you know, this PAL version of Altered Beast, you are getting it in full 60Hz. Speed. So in a lot of ways, you're trying to pick up a Mega Drive now, you want to do everything. This has got, you know, full six button pad on there, which you can switch between. You've got a mode button to switch between it. You know, it'll play Mega Drive games in 60Hz. It'll output to the TV, and if Tony just flips it up and shows the bottom, you'll see there's a port on there as well to connect to second controller, so you can play full two player as well. So
it's a comprehensive bit of kit, I think.
It's definitely one of those kind of jack of all trades. If you can find one now, I mean, you're looking to pay about, you know, anything from 100 quid up to 250 to get one of these, you know, depending on the condition and everything. Would the PAL NTSC converter monstrosity work on this? Not entirely sure, Paul. Don't own one myself. I do know that obviously if you're using something like the EverDrive, which I do use regular. I mean, I've got all the different ROMs on there, so at least the EverDrive does work. So you can pick the NTSC ROMs if you need to. Hacks and everything will work. The one thing that won't work from stock is the Master System converter.
Sadly. Really?
Yeah. The only thing it hasn't got that a Mega Drive has got, it hasn't got inbuilt Master System support.
Alright.
But the mod. No. It is there.
Don't want it then.
It's on the board, but they never implemented it. You literally have to swap around two wires, and it adds Master System support back in.
Was that an intentional or was that an oversight or what?
I don't know whether they were just trying to phase out. Usually when they do something like that, if they add in a feature which isn't costing any more, for them to take it out usually means they found some kind of bug somewhere which they wouldn't want people finding out about.
And I haven't the machine look potentially a bit dodgy.
The sound's top end. The speaker hasn't been modified on that. I think the caps have been redone on it, so it's outputting really good sound.
It's got bassy as well. It's got everything in it.
It's got some punch in it. Yeah. Oh, and it is outputting. I think it's only mono sound on this, but it does output stereo sound when you output to the TV, which is good. You've got a headphone jack on there as well. The only thing it lacks, obviously, is a reset switch. So for the... Everyone goes on about this, but the one game, is it one of the X-Men games?
What do I have? Oh, yeah, there's an X-Men game where to start the game, you need to press reset. So it's all sort of unplayable.
What's the point of that?
I don't know,
it was like a gimmick. I think you get to a certain stage and there's like a supercomputer. And like on the game, you need to reboot the computer, so it breaks the fourth wall by making you press the reset button on your Mega Drive, and then it proceeds the game from the continuing on the level. But you can't do that on this because you haven't got a physical reset button. You can add one in. Why you'd want to do that is beyond me.
You're literally adding it in for that game,
yeah. Yeah, exactly. And as already mentioned, the screen quality looks really good on this. It's a bit too good on camera, but in person. The screen quality means there's no ghosting, it's really bright, it's really clear, and you haven't got any kind of weird viewing angles. I mean, we're looking at this from, 150 degrees here, and it's still perfectly clear because this isn't the original screen. I'm kind of sad to say, but glad to say, because as anybody who's ever seen old LCD technology, you know that it sucks dick.
So, was the old screen close to the Game Gear type?
It was virtually identical.
Oh, that shit then.
There was only a time difference of about 2 years, I think, between the Game Gear and this appearing. And this was actually based on the Mega Jet. You ever heard of the Mega Jet?
Yeah. The one that was on the airplanes.
That's right. It was on airplanes, and it was in hotels in Japan, I think. It was like a rental system. And it was just like a handheld Mega Drive with no screen that you could plug into.
It was like a bar, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right. Well, they took that technology and put it into this to create this. But I think they were missing the market a bit, and the price of it just kind of forced it out there, if you know what I mean. But yeah, the screen they were using was from a Game Gear, and you had like a proper bulb at the back. And that was responsible for sucking most of the juice. Mm. That's why the battery life was so bad. I think the standard battery life on this back in the day, I think it was about 2.5 hours on 6 batteries. You know what I mean? You'd chew through Duracells in that time. You know, imagine the costs.
You get out of this?
Yeah, on 6 batteries now with this modern LCD screen, you're probably going to get about 6.5 hours.
I do write more Game Gear, even though it's the original screen, it's modded with an LED.
Yeah.
So you get quite a lot of extra battery life out of that.
Battery life was always a weird thing back in the day. I mean, back to the Game Gear and that. I mean, did you ever have a Game Gear back in the day, or recently acquired one?
Yeah.
See, I had a Game Gear, and like all my mates had Game Boys, and I love the Game Boy, but I was sold on the Game Gear because it had colour, because it had, you know.
It was like playing your Mega Drive portable.
Yeah, it was. I mean, technically speaking, the Game Gear actually improved on the Mega Drive in one aspect. Do you know what that was?
The Master System.
Eh?
Improved on the Master System.
No, the Game Gear improved on the Mega Drive.
Did it? Colours?
Bigger colour palette. Yeah.
Than the Mega Drive.
That's more your fucking area of expertise, isn't it?
So I should know
the
that
Game Gear did.
Yeah, the Game Gear.
I knew it had more than the Master System.
Yeah, I don't know if you'd had access to a full bigger palette, but I know for sure. It allowed more on-screen colours than the Mega Drive did.
That's mad.
Yeah. It is mad to think that they kind of did that, and that was because a lot of people ask why. I'm clearing up you Sega fanboys now. the Master System, like everyone asked why they never did like a Game Gear converter the same way Nintendo like did the Super Game Boy, and it was because the Game Gear spec was higher than the Mega Drive in some aspects, and the Mega Drive couldn't recreate that, and yet lower in other regards, and that was why it never happened. Although in recent years, we were at an event, weren't we, a couple of weeks ago, for Yorkshire CosplayCon, and you were playing a few things there on the EverDrive, weren't you, which were quite cool. And what they are is, like, now you can convert Game Gear games to run on a Mega Drive. So what they do is they run, they've got a slightly limited palette compared to the Game Gear, but you get to see a lot more, you see some weird quirks, like the fact that it draws more than the Game Gear screen could ever show, because we were playing Game Gear Shinobi, weren't we?
Yeah.
And like you can see a lot more of the field that you're actually playing, and playing like the Sonic games that were only on the Game Gear, you've got a full play field like you would have had on the Master System. It's really strange. In fact, we can pair that up and show you that in a minute as well.
You can do that while I'm playing this. Carry on.
You're glued to it now, aren't you? Yeah. So,
see if you can do that next, boss.
Oh, no. I'm quite surprised I did this one so easily.
Which boss is next? The bear?
The eyes.
No, we're still on level 2.
On level 2, of course, you passed it there, maybe. So, but bear in mind, all the batteries that are in there have pretty much ran nearly flat. And we've been playing this now for like 30 minutes with full sound up. And it's still going, even though it says the battery's low. I know with the original screen, when the battery light came on, you had about 15 minutes before it was dead. So that shows you that it's
streaming. What was the total battery life on it originally?
Originally, like I say, a full rack of batteries is about 2.5 hours. If you had volume on and everything, about 2.5 hours of play. That's not a lot at all. It's, I mean, like my Game Gear, I used to run my Game Gear from the wall.
What was the Game Gear? It couldn't have been...
The Game Gear, I think they advertised it was about 6 to 8 hours battery life.
Oh, God.
You were lucky.
Sorry, I used to have to plug it into my mum's car, like, fucking... There we go.
Well, that's it.
See, look, I fucked up. I got caught in first time round. I missed one of the power ups. Told you.
I suck. That should be the challenge.
I'm gonna die now.
What, for Altered Beast?
Yeah.
Somebody, we're doing Ghouls and Ghosts first.
So somebody on my Facebook was doing a challenge not long ago, and I did do it. That was before I started doing the live stream for Yam Yam, and it was Altered Beast high score run, and everybody else was doing kind of slightly like naff runs and stuff. And I tested it to destruction. I realised how you could point scab dead easily. It was brilliant.
Well, I'm all right at Altered Beast. My missus, fuck me. She's unreal at Altered Beast for some reason.
This D-pad's brilliant.
It is great. It's and the more you play with it, you realise how smooth it is.
It's better than the original Mega Drive pads.
And even with the weird shaped buttons, they don't feel odd, do they? They've got the proper responsiveness, yeah. You know what I mean?
If you bent your hand that way, it's even better. It like, fits with a slant. Go on, do it with your little
girly
hands.
Sure, we measured hands on our last podcast.
Mine was about a mil bigger than
yours.
So I've got shorter hands compared to you.
Yeah, but I've got longer pubes.
Was it right before you measured dicks, was it?
Yeah, and I've got longer pubes.
Oh yeah, I won that competition. We was going for the smallest cock, were we?
Yeah.
I won.
You won by a mile.
Well done. A mile?
Comprehensively won.
Yo! Oh,
did you beat him?
Yeah, man.
Nice.
Don't fuck him
out.
Not first time round, though.
Yeah. That was pretty cool. John, you know my back.
Yeah, I do want him back.
He needs a challenge now. I'm not cheap boy. I'm just getting passed around at the minute.
There you go. Well, think of all the germs on that. You don't know where I've been.
Nah, that's, I do. So that's a sad thing.
Yeah, I've definitely had a wash today.
That'll be bleached before he goes back home.
And Craig have.
It was my birthday a fortnight ago.
Oh, yeah. I seem moderately clean.
Yeah.
For you.
For me.
So, that was the Sega Nomad. So, verdicts. Something, yes or no?
Oh, I'd definitely buy one if I had the money. 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
So, Sega fanboys definitely won over. Right, next thing I want to show is the... we'll go with the Megazord because...
put the telly on then, boy.
Yeah, because it's already plugged in, so I'm just doing this for convenience, really.
What's it on? The source I've got to put it on?
Whatever your Mega Drive is on.
It's a composite there.
Yeah. See, you get warts and all on these streams, guys.
How it was intended.
We've had a few guys log on and off here, you know. We've got Dana logging on and off. We've got Paul logging on and off. It is the middle of the day, so most people are at work, but...
losers.
So,
well, that's a nice buzz.
It is a nice buzz.
So never does that.
Is that something to do with the shielding?
Yeah, you might find that's to do with it. Probably go off when the game's on. So we've got all three hooked up here. This is, I would say, is the best setup for. Ooh, it is cracking quite a bit, isn't it?
Yeah, it never normally does that. So
this is the best setup for a 32X. It looks the most aesthetically pleasing, if that's a thing.
Into the main CD.
Now he has.
That's the back of the telly. Well, that's weird, man.
Try just taking it out of the Mega CD.
Taking what out?
The Mega Drive, because the Mega Drive is plugged into the Mega CD.
No,
it's all one plug.
You can't, it's all in one plug.
All right. Not that.
No,
don't
do
that. That was a fucking stupid idea, Harry.
Yeah.
Sorry, what's the volume on for the telly? Yeah, you get the volume cranked, have you? And you don't realise it.
No,
that's
really...
It is affected by the volume, so... It's all right, we'll check in a second, anyway.
What are you putting on two players, so... So I'm playing, I'm drinking. I don't like fucking video games. It's losers.
Hello. Nerds, man.
Right, before you launch them.
Okay.
So obviously the 32X was the difficult third album in the Mega Drive repertoire, I think. If you want to give a music analogy for these band going freaks here. Obviously the Mega
Do you want a drink, Tom?
I've got one.
Yeah. I'll have one of his cube, mate.
Peace.
Yeah, man.
So we got the you got the Mega Drive 2, which was inferior to the original Mega Drive, isn't that right?
Yeah, it was like the cheaper budget build, wore it. There was little issues, and it was a bit crap. And
you got solenoid there by Mike, didn't you?
That's Mike's Mega Drive 2 from when he was a kid, yeah. So he's got a.
So I'm sentimental about that bitch.
Come on, give us a story, Mike. Let's hear your X Factor piece.
Nothing. I've stopped that since I was a kid. Kept it. I used to be harmless for a bit, and still kept that safe. So if anybody wants to fight me for that. 19 enlarged drive, let's have it.
It's a no from me.
you got to talk about dead cats and stuff if you want to get through.
You pulled on my heartstrings, but still a no.
Oh, you want an X? Alright, okay. Proper X Factor story. Eh?
Yeah.
Pop. You got to zoom in with a camera in and out like that, flashing.
So yeah, Mega Drive 2, perfectly acceptable Mega Drive.
Radiant!
Especially when you've got a sob story attached to it.
Yeah.
And attached to that, we've got its dodgy, malformed Siamese twin.
I can't stand that side one. I'd rather have the Mark 1.
Yeah, the Mega CD 2, which obviously, I mean, to be honest, I mean, I like the Mega CD 1 better. It looked more futuristic for the 80s.
But there's less to go wrong on that because there's no fucking.
Yeah, there's less also, moving parts.
I paid £30 for that.
£30? How long ago was that?
Last year.
You did well then.
Nick?
No, we don't talk about Nick. He don't listen to the podcast.
That bitch at the fucking shit CX.
Yeah, we don't talk about him no more.
We don't talk about Nick
now. Well, our first two podcasts, we bigged up Nick loads, and then we tagged him in the podcast, and he just ignored us. So fucking, we talk about...
Everybody ignores us, so...
We talk about CX then.
So, yeah, the Mega CD 2 anyway. Mega CD 2... strange system in itself, you know, it should have been awesome and it turned out to be mediocre because the game.
It should have been standalone.
Yeah, I mean, it should have been its own system and they needed to put more hardware in there, but it was 1991, was it? A bit early, I think, for CD based systems.
I think it was after 91, maybe 93?
Nobody really knew what to do with all that extra space, so FMV games became popular. And as we all know, as time has shown, FMV games suck the fat one. So, yeah. You know, it had some great ports and stuff. I mean, have you played Streets of Rage on there with the enhanced sound and
I
stuff?
I love it, EAT.
I hate it.
You're not a fan of it?
I hate it.
He hates the enhanced sound.
It's because, obviously, like what Tony Spark wrote before, it's all a memory trigger. So, like, I hear the proper sound, that's my memory trigger. I hear that new one, I'm like, I want that sound, not the new one.
Okay, I'll get ya.
So it's a memory trigger for everything, Jarman. I mean, I hear that noise and I'm like, yeah, I'm saying I'm 10 again.
Yeah, but I mean, you never got to experience that. So I think the novelty of playing it...
Yeah, it was cool, but I just can't do it.
You know, it's even worse. I gave him that game because I thought he'd love it. You know, the one with the with Shinobi.
You're
on.
Ungrateful, I gave it bastard.
And then I come around and I was like, did you play it? Because yeah, fucking whack. I was like, alright, mate, it's
hard. You're literally everything I play, he's like, whack. When we were playing games at Bonfire, playing Street Fighter, like, this is whack. This game's whack. As everything you've got is whack.
Ungrateful cunt.
It's the Star Wars thing, isn't it? You remaster Star Wars and people want original Star Wars, they don't want all the fucking
glitz and glamour.
Extra bells and whistles on it. You
want
to remember as it was. Yeah.
But do you know if George Lucas gave you a copy of the remastered Star Wars and you'd never seen it before and well, he gave because he knew you were a Star Wars fan, when George Lucas come around the next day would you go, that was fucking shit, George? You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, but you've just said you've never seen it before. Right?
Yeah, that's the... That's a shabby analogy. Yeah. If I'd seen it before, I was like, George,
can you believe these guys?
I want it exactly as it was.
Give it back. Yeah. I'll take it. I'll have two copies.
Yeah, fucking.
If you've seen it before, then you've got nothing to offend, have you?
So I saw some controversy there talking about the Mega CD.
That's right.
But, so like I said, the difficult third act...
Hang on, what are being phased out?
Start to
all right, Beyonce.
Fuck me.
So the 32X, right, 32X was the one that nobody owned, as far as I know. Did you know anyone back in the day who owned a 32X?
I never knew a single person who had one.
No. My dad had one.
Your dad had one?
Yeah, he said it once, and then he'd never do it again, because he was like, this is ball-like, and it stopped in the packaging, looked like it's brand new.
Well, let's not forget, back in the day, you had, that was the biggest Achilles heel, the whole three pterodactyl thing. I mean, that is fucking unreasonable.
And then big fucking clubs as well. Or, you know what I mean?
It's unreasonable.
It's unreasonable.
Yam Yam came out because it was all virtual race, and he couldn't stand racing games. He was just like fucked off by the whole fucking thing.
Now, to be fair, I mean, talking about the games and stuff, I mean, the games that are available on the 32X, you can see a few of them up on screen there. They are a lot better than what was available on the Mega CD.
That's
on the whole.
That's virtually the entire library.
Well, that's the only thing, yeah, because it flopped so bad, that is virtually the entire library. Admittedly, those are the only the PAL releases you got up.
This was just before the Saturn. Yeah,
this was the time where Sega shat a collective brick because they wanted to launch about 50 fucking consoles.
Was it originally going to be called the Sega Pluto or something? It'd be a standalone console.
Yeah, well, you had there was talk about the 32X being on sale. That would have been the Mars, I think that was going to be. They were talking about one called the Mars. They were doing this whole planet thing at the time, weren't they? And in the end, the only one that came to fruition was the Saturn, obviously, which we can
more like your age.
See there in his cubbyhole. Yeah, you know what I mean? Hey, you ain't going to tell me. I'm not a big fan of the Saturn.
Whoa.
Oh, no, I'm in the 32X. The Saturn's great.
Oh, I've got a love-hate relationship with the Saturn.
I've got a love-love relationship with it. I love it, then I love it some more.
Yeah, but you can see there's already a big problem when you talk about the Saturn. When you talk about the Saturn, you got to talk about what's underneath it. And when you talk about what's underneath it, the Saturn can go suck a fuck, basically.
Nah, it's got its place.
Its place really should be underneath.
Yeah.
There's
a hierarchy.
If that was an ersatz gay relationship, the Saturn would be the bottom.
No chance.
Definitely, the Saturn would be the bottom.
Oh, the PlayStation was great, but everything out of the water when it came out, it really did. But the Saturn, I still love it.
Yeah, it had its moments. But yeah, the 32X anyway, so nobody had one. What did it cost back in the day?
150 quid more, yeah, I think.
Got to have been something ridiculous. And what was a Mega Drive good for at the time?
Probably 99, something like that.
So you're paying more for that, this fucking mushroom thing you're sticking the top of it, with a library of what, 30 games?
Something
tops,
stupid.
And at release, what, 3 or 4 at best, was it?
Yeah.
So, you know, no, you had to own a Mega Drive, and by then people were already looking at the next generation systems. And they released the 32X to, let's say it was lukewarm at best. So nobody ever owned it. So for most, you know, Sega boys I speak to, a lot of them have never even played on this damn thing. So we've got it up anyway. The games are ridiculously expensive, and like I say, I don't own any. So
the only reason I'd have one would be for like the exclusives like Calibri, Knuckles and Chaotix. And I accidentally mark off for 2 games.
No.
Fuck that.
It's stupid. Well, I saw Kartux go recently. I think Nick had a copy go for his paws.
I think Scott, the bloke who works
Scott,
with him,
yeah,
I think
yeah.
he had it. And I think...
They're 200 quid, weren't it? Just for Kartux.
Yeah.
That's stupid money. It's like when you bet... I mean, we just talked about the Nomad. I think I paid just... Was it 180, I think, I paid for my Nomad over there. And that's like a rare console you get in, which you can play anything on. Or 200 quid just to play a kind of slightly off Sonic game. It doesn't make any sense to me. That's why, I mean, I talk about it a lot, but that's why I'm a hardware collector and not a software collector. So, yeah, so the 32X, did you ever play on one back in the day at all, any of you?
At a shop.
I did.
You did play on one? You always said you did.
Oh, no, that reminds me. I did know somebody who had one. A bit weird. We had
was
a Well, he was a bit weird, as in he was a maths teacher at a fucking shitty... secondary school
did
on a council estate.
Did you get to play his 32X?
No, he was just a great bloke, and he'd open up his... Don't say arse, I know that's what you were going to say. Opened up his classroom to...
I was going to say flies, because he was like sucking his dick.
And he'd set loads of consoles up on a dinner time, and as long as you weren't a twat, you could come in and play.
So you never got to play?
So I never got to play. I was pressed up against the window. And he got a 32X, and he got Virtua Racing, and I played then.
Huh, there you go. So at least
big shout out to Mr. Gamster. Not that he's ever going to fucking listen.
Is he even alive anymore?
I hope so. He was
I
a fucking ace.
I hope not for his paedophilia.
He was not a paedophile. He was a great bloke.
Setting up games consoles for kids.
We did have a paedophile as a teacher, and he was the PE teacher. I mean, he never came out. And he's never come out, but he was.
Yeah.
He was like, "Are you naughty? You two boys have been naughty. Shake hands."
We had a teacher who we never suspected, but he's now officially on the registry, made the news and everything. He got sent down, and he got sent down in a big way for being a pedo.
We had a teacher. We used to have to run the gambit for the showers. You know, we used to fancy showering a kid, did you? But you see, going, you have showers.
Was running
and he'd stand there at the end, and he'd just look at all of us. as he was showering.
It's like, sir,
there's always a PE teacher.
We didn't do any PE today. It was raining. We had to sit in the classroom. Why are you making us have a shower?
Why are you making us have a shower with you as well? You, I don't know, PE.
Well, what's it? Why was showering
you? Standing in the corner, fully dressed, watching the shower.
And he used to soap us up.
Terrified,
Mr. Roberts. He used to soap Mr. Roberts. Yeah, fair play.
With his special loofah.
He was like,
it's raining. I'll wash it as quickly as I want.
You gotta make sure you're clean. Bend over, I'll get it in. Oh, I'm here now. He's better than it being my dad all the time.
Well, yeah.
Hang on, we had a live stream here somewhere.
Yeah, we did, yeah. So anyway, on to a less controversial subject. We've got the 32X in, and we've got it set up, and we've got the UK games there. Any of those ring a bell, fellas?
A few.
Star Wars Arcade,
yeah.
Tough man.
Tough man, have you? I've never even touched on it. Never seen it at all.
Mortal Kombat 2 rings a bell.
Well, yeah, I think Mortal Kombat, you know. And you know what? It is a really good version. It definitely improves. I say it improves on the Mega Drive. It's what the Mega Drive version should have been, really. The Mega Drive version should have been as good as that. I think they kind of rushed it out a little bit. It could have been as good as that, as it stood. But it's still not as good as the SNES version. I'm sorry, not by a long shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're talking about two now, not one.
Whatever.
Look at these men getting angry, they just love it.
He used to make games for Nintendo, so he's going to verge more that way.
Well, he was buying them, you know what I mean?
Verging on the ridiculous.
Yeah. I'll tell you a story about that, though. One of the main guys at Sega, I forget his first name, something Nielsen. I was reading a thing about him the other day.
Leslie?
Could be.
Bridget?
Could be. We'll Google it. Anyway. He said about the 32X, he said he wasn't a fan of it because the Saturn was right around the corner, the new was right around the corner, so there was no fucking need for him to bring the 32X out at all. He was one of the main guys at Sega, and he was against it.
They really were having a shit fit around that time, that they made some crappy decisions.
Oh, yeah, they dropped the bollocks with the
32X. And you know what, you've got to address it because it was the decisions then that ultimately made Sega disappear off the place of the fucking planet. He buried them in the arcades, he buried them in the sixth generation, and that's why we never got anything after the fucking Dreamcast. I know, yeah. You know what, I might like my Nintendo, but I've got equal... A lot of people think this, but I've got equal love for Sega, and it is... bullshit what happened. And if they had just kind of buried the differences and Sega Japan and Sega America had stopped arguing, they might have seen a Dreamcast 2 or a resurgence in the arcades.
The Japanese ate in the round eyes.
It was.
Oh, yes, we spoke about that at length.
Very much exactly what it was. So, yeah, the 32X anyway. So we've got some good titles on here. The system itself had some good games. Which one do you want to take a crack at first and talk about? Anything on there that you've got an affinity to, or you have got memories of? I know, as there's a couple of games you mentioned. One of them, sadly, we can't play, is Calibri, because I haven't got the. I don't think it actually got a European release.
I have no idea, mate. Not a clue.
That could be why I haven't got it on there, because I think this was a complete ROM set I put on there, so we can't play Calibri because I haven't got a modded system.
Didn't Raw come out on the PlayStation though? I thought that was a PlayStation game.
Yeah, quite a few of these games. I mean, looking down that list, Afterburner Complete, it's basically the same as the original Afterburners. Nothing too special about it. Cosmic Carnage, was that a Mega Drive game?
On the N64 as well?
Yeah, it was on the N64. I had it for PlayStation.
You might be thinking of Total Carnage, the Spider-Man game.
That could be actually, yeah. Darkside, is that 32X only?
I have no idea. Don't know what it is.
FIFA Soccer, obviously FIFA end up on everything. Doom, now, you know what, throw Doom on, because this is one of the best, Doom ports that there was. The reason being is that, press C again, or B, whatever it was, but no, press A now, and again.
So you can tell he's fucking Nintendo. That's it. The wrong buttons.
Why do I press C there?
If you use Ever Drives a lot, you always know it's the button nearest to the inside, the like button one.
That
on
makes all the sense of the world. I don't know why I went for that. Just
obviously,
what it does, the Ever Drives.
Yeah, going to come up syntax errors.
It dumps it takes the ROM and it dumps it into, it temporarily flashes it into like a RAM chip, and that's how it reads it. Once you've loaded it in, if you reset it, if you just press start, it'll go straight back into the game. So, Ever Drives are brilliant, but there are catches in that you've only got so many redrive cycles, so they might die eventually.
I'll tell you.
And then, like, Sonic in a ball, cool. It's like he's going to cross it.
So, oh, listen to that awful music.
I know, yeah. I know we've got a little bit of feedback going on. Oh, before you start, I should just mention that. I think the reason for some of the feedback, I think there's a little bit of feedback from the power supply being used. And the fact that the 32X didn't actually have great shielding, there's these little weird metal clips you have to put inside that block the RF signals, and I think it's to do with that. I don't think I've inserted them properly, so...
The graphics are great. Yeah. Because it's contemporary console-wise would have been Doom on the SNES. Now, people ripped that, but back in the day, that was all you had if you're a console gamer, and I personally loved it, playing it to death. But the graphics were nowhere near as good as this. But the sound, I still think the SNES version has got the best Doom soundtrack out of all the Dooms of the day.
The SNES had way better sound capabilities than the Mega Drive ever did, even with the 32X. That was just a fact. Obviously, the Mega Drive came out of an era where they were still using the Yamaha sound chip for everything, you know, and that's why it carried the Yamaha sound chip, but it couldn't do... the same kind of orchestra kind of sound.
Is that all you've got to go through?
I think it doubles up on this. I think action and...
Oh no, that's the solid strafe, isn't it?
So. I think it is the strafe button. Yeah, if you go to the door and tap strafe, I think that's what does it.
Okay.
Now, the reason this looks so good, I think we talked about this briefly at the event the other week, as because this one was actually handled by John Carmack. And I think that's why it looks so good, because he handled the coding on it, or at least had a bigger hand in it than he did on any of the other systems. I think he worked on this in the Jaguar port, and that's why the Jaguar port was so good as well.
The Jaguar port, I don't think that's got any music, has it?
The Jaguar port hasn't got the music, because it didn't have the room on the cartridge. That was the bottom line. I mean, the music might be a bit average in quality, but at least it's there. You know what I mean?
I'd rather have it than... I mean, it makes it a bit atmospheric, I suppose, having no music. But, what are the standout features of Doom? Well, everything was a standout feature, including the music. I mean, a lot of people who ain't heavy metal, like myself, a lot of the tunes and rip-offs of, like, Megadeth and Slayer and Metallica, stuff like that. I think Level 1, I think this is a Megadeth tune.
Interesting fact as well, might as well mention it now. Tell me, you're an admirer of Jim Bagley's work, aren't you?
I am.
Jim Bagley actually worked on the Saturn port of Doom.
I hope to sign mine.
You did sign it, did you? I had John Romero sign my 3DO version, which was...
did he look at you through the corner of his eye?
He said, 3DO version, that's interesting. I've not seen one of those in years. I said, yeah, there's good reason. So I've still got that at home. Now, Jim worked on the Saturn port, and there's a bit of a Sarah story with that. Now, you're going to be meeting Jim for the first time in a week's time at Revival, aren't you? And he'll be able to tell you a story if you ask him about it, so we'll see where that goes. But basically, there was an issue regarding the coding, because Jim and his team devised a way of making the game run at a full 60, I think it was 60 frames per second on the Saturn. So they unleashed more power than it could actually was capable of on the PC. And when he actually returned and showed that version to John Carmack shit a brick, because he thought it was going to harm the sales of the other ports, and told him that he couldn't use the technique he was using to achieve that. And instead he toned it down and ended up with a slightly shit hacked port on the Saturn, which Jim
was
really pissed
off about.
Just in case
it was something.
Yeah, you never know, yeah.
Oh, I just finished this up.
That door
there.
I just thought there might be
different
extra
stuff.
There is. Do you want me to shed to know there?
Well,
I'm sure I should have thought of
you
on my
door.
Go back through there. Through the other door. Turn left. See that
grey
wall?
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Kind of gives it away,
though,
because
the
colour
palettes. What they can do is, like, fucking same game.
Yeah, in a lot of ways, yeah.
Like, really.
But you can look up and down.
Quake, yeah, you could.
I really struggled with that on the 64.
Oh, it's quite difficult with the 64 joypad.
Yeah, it's really struggled with that.
Everything's difficult on the 64, yeah. Because the 64, as I said before, you think I'm a Nintendo boy. I fucking hate the Nintendo 64.
When you're out there, turn left. Now, go back through that wall.
Oh, is that another secret?
Yeah. Turn left. Turn right. Oh, you can go over there now.
You're giving away all the secrets. People can pay for this shit.
There's a shotgun in there. Get that. Now, turn left. You see that wall there? Turn right.
Okay. See that corner? To the big end.
Right, that corner will come down. You've got to be quick.
Get them cheats.
Right, so turn left. Go back across there. No, that way, turn right, sorry.
Go to across there, the left axis. Again,
sorry. You see the shadow there on the floor?
Oh, it's
so hard. That's a trigger. Just run, that's it. Turn round, stay on the spot, turn round. Other way. That's it. Now,
as have you ever
run across. Life? Run across that as fast as you can and try and get back to that corner I showed you.
So you'll sprint across the acid?
Yeah. Just keep going, keep going.
Oh,
keep
there,
going.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Oh!
That's
all
the secrets
are.
On this
See,
room.
I never knew that.
What have you
ever
done with
your
life? Like, what the fuck?
Hey, mate, I don't mind being a virgin, because I know what all the secrets I'm
on there. How's it going, Bill? Nice to see you on here, mate. We were talking about you earlier. Not in a bad way.
The shadow was a trigger over here, didn't it?
Because when you walk across it...
You've got to sprint like a bastard.
If you listen carefully, you can hear a...
Oh, you don't. Oh, too slow.
There should be a run button. I don't know whether it doubles up as the strafe if you hold it down.
Might.
You know what?
There you go.
I's the run right in. Just changes everything. Right.
Before you run back, give me a second because it's already come down.
Yeah.
Give me a second to go back up.
That draw no distance. Go. Of course, Eve.
Sprint, yeah, just douse snag, that's it. You're there. You've got it. There you go, you're all learning a bit here, people, as you're watching.
In the PlayStation version, if you play it on the hardest difficulty, there's a pain elemental up there, the one that fires lost souls. Because that was never a Doom 1 enemy.
There's a few enemies missing from this, isn't there?
No, this is the proper version. There shouldn't be anything up
there.
Oh,
so the PlayStation added it.
Version put it in.
See, my first prop. I mean, I played Doom on the PC back in the day. We installed it on the school library, which was one of the starting catalysts for why they started putting locks in all the distros. But yeah, we installed Doom on the library at school. We never got really long to play it. Not when we also had PCs back in the day. So my real first exposure to Doom was when I got it on the PlayStation. And on the PlayStation port, it is mint, isn't it?
How'd you change your weapons?
You know all the secrets, but you don't have to change your weapon.
Actually, I played a. Nope. I had Doom on the PC. My dad had a PC, and I played Doom on the PC.
How the fuck do you change your weapons?
Do you have to hold strafe and tap something, maybe?
Maybe double tap B. It's weird, isn't it?
Try two buttons together and stop bashing my fucking pad before I bash your head.
Try A and C.
Come on, Az.
Oh, hang on, I'm holding start and nothing's happening. So maybe.
Look at controls, you prick.
Yeah, it's controls.
Oh.
Right, yeah, well, you know what?
Oh, hold, take it back.
Hold C and press A. Or hold C and press up and down.
I mean, it's not over here.
I'm gonna have no fucking pad left.
This game's shit.
Does anybody know how to change weapon on 32X Doom?
Yeah, buy a 6-foot joypad.
Oh, Bill, we were just talking about your contribution towards the recent Games Animal TV, mate. That's what we were talking about. I understand you gave David your assistance with producing the credits, so...
This is stupid. This is ridiculous.
You've got to be able to work it out.
You can help me produce some stuff for us if you want, because I got the fucking time. It's finding time to actually get to do stuff that you want to fucking do.
Tell me about it. Well, I mean, I've got, like, you know, my main business, which I'm winding down. I've got the event stuff to do. And then, like, I'm trying to do these things. I'm trying to get some practice in for various reasons. And it's just finding time for everything. Then you've got life and that. I mean, you're getting married. I've got fucking things going on with family and that. I've got a house to fucking renovate. You know, there's a lot of shit going on.
So I get literally from 7 o'clock, because I work all week and then I get Fridays off. That's podcast day. So from 7 o'clock till 4, I've got to do everything. Like, do the podcast, edit it. Then if I do anything for the YouTube channel, I've got to learn how to do that.
What was that? You just collected?
Mega health, put your health up to 200. Another secret place.
Yeah, it's all about finding the time to do things. And
well, you know what? I rarely find time to game these days.
Yeah, I'm struggling at the minute.
A lot of people ask me, they say, oh man, you got all this stuff. Well, you know, I bet you're playing all the time. And then it's like, I'm really not.
You should just give it all to me.
Ah, Paul says hold mode and then press A, B, C for weapon change. You haven't got mode.
That's 6-button joypad, that's what we need.
So you need a 36-button joypad? Yeah. Bloody hell.
Sorry about my inferior controllers.
This is disgusting.
You know what, those pads have got mode on, you could use one of them, but it doesn't matter.
The fuck it does matter, I'm stuck to the bloody chain gun then.
Well, tough, you're sticking with your chain gun, okay?
Do you want to try different games?
Yeah, we can this.
I was enjoying that.
So that's Doom anyway, and it is a good game.
He plays well.
That music, gonna say though, this level of music, that sucks dick, doesn't it? That's fucking terrible.
It's horrible.
So he's setting.
He's like, no, I'm looking
at. Oh, we have got a smoke machine in here, by the way. It's just Mike, and he's massive. He's fucking.
Yeah, my massive. Yeah. Stop there.
The only time I smoke, you want to come over here?
Oh, shouldn't
production
have
production
values. Yeah.
Did you press start then?
I don't press.
What have I done?
Yeah, what I do. What I'm not going to play again.
No, I think I have to turn it off rather than press reset.
You do, you have to turn it off. You press reset, it goes straight back to you.
Right.
You said that earlier.
Okay, so, yeah, or press A.
In case you pull off.
It's dead.
He does tend to tangle pads, Aaron does. I know it's set with a lot of
his own.
Tangles
life.
I'll edit you from our fucking edge.
I wish I could.
Hey, Mike. You put something on now.
Okay. Right, so press A, Mike.
Ultimate 2 players.
And go to ROMs.
More combat.
32X ROMs, and then Europe. So pick a game. What takes your fancy?
Come on, let's do it, Tom.
You can have a brawl.
I'm going to go for it.
So what are the systems you just released on then?
Well, N64, we had that one. You had the PS1,
yeah. PlayStation 1, yeah.
Yeah, but you're talking, okay, what are the 16-bit systems was it released on? Because even though technically they say this is 32-bit, it only really had the capabilities of a 16-bit with a little bit more on top, didn't it? It hasn't got many more tricks up its sleeve than a Mega Drive, really.
So why the fuck did they bother bringing it out?
That's the question.
The only thing I think they added to it was sprite scaling, I think a couple of extra sound channels, and that's about it.
Do you think they maybe brought it to try and keep them relevant in the market?
They claimed it was to extend the life of the Mega Drive, but the Mega Drive was still doing well. It didn't need it.
Yeah,
you
still...
Is that the role I'm thinking about?
No, it's not.
What
were
you thinking?
Is it the role I play is different to these because I haven't got none of them logos.
Yeah, I'll say that's ticks it all the right along, isn't it? Yeah.
No, this is different to the one I play for the PlayStation.
What's this, the block edition?
So.
The fuck was that?
I don't know, I just pressed start and everything. Yeah.
I mean, that music's awful. That's wow. Shitty Mega Drive music.
Okay, so C for that one. We do one-on-one. One-four-one. Bit of Owen Hart.
Who's that?
Who the fuck is that?
You and Mash on.
Never even heard of that.
I've got to do it. I've got to be the phenom.
Yeah, is Lex Luger in this as well then?
Bam Bam Bigelow.
There you go.
Lex is fucking bad boy.
I'll just be dying.
Oh man.
Shawn Michaels.
Could you do a Hell in a Cell?
The 1-2-3
Diesel. See this was the weird point where WWF was becoming WWE at this time.
No,
this time.
It was way after.
Was it way after this?
Way after.
But they were starting to change their image at this point, weren't they? They were going from the kind of colourful, crazy characters to the leather-bound gimps.
This was the golden era of Warwick Town. Then they went from golden to...
This was golden, man. 5 years before, this was golden.
You got Hogan, Macho Man, all them, isn't there?
But most of them was on the... That was all there with that.
They were around.
They couldn't get the license at this point.
Maybe. And what year was this? Did this come out then?
95. It said on the copyrights.
You know.
Slingshot suplex finishing move. I can't remember that being his fucking finishing move.
No, I've got to be honest. Me neither.
Is it loading or what?
Yeah. Oh, now they've gone back.
Press start. Someone.
Press the start. Sledge wrestler. So, hang on.
Yeah, press C.
There you go. Start game C.
What kind of bullshit was that?
What is this?
Oh, this is completely
different. Oh, this is just like the Mega Drive wrestling WWF games.
Why does Taker look like Jake the Snake?
You know what? We never got a decent 16-bit WWF wrestling game. I'm not going to say we didn't get a decent wrestling game, because we did. We played Saturday Night Slam Masters.
Whoa! Oh God! I'm God!
I've got in trouble.
Oh shit! Get back in the ring, you prick! Have that.
Oh, big daddy smash.
You know what? 10 points to the first person who can pull off a move, because it was always so fucking difficult to do anything on this.
Oh, here we go. Is this my chance?
No!
Yes! Yep, taker. Smack him about. Jake the Snake's taker. Fucking hell. No.
I'm down for the count. Oh, yes. Get over there.
Does that class as a move?
This is
going to... It's a standard body slam to the mouse. You're up against the rope.
Have that. It's hilarious.
It's terrible, but we're at the same
Look
time.
How crap the animation is. Like, it's like...
Oh, can't believe him.
There's no need for this to be on a 30.
As us, why when he runs into the rope, does he knock himself out? I'm with you, I know.
Because it's not a very well-made game, wasn't
it? Oh, man.
Is it LJN who were dealing with these versions?
I want that chair. I'm not sure I'll get that chair. It's a sitter, isn't it?
Yeah. You might have to
a
get
chair,
it going.
It's usually a sitter, yeah.
Come here, you little bitch! Oh, got that.
See, now this game is the very problem as to why the 32X fell on its arse, because you look at this.
The kicky! I'm dead.
There's nothing special with the gameplay. It looks no different to the 16-bit...
Looks now better.
It's identical to the other WF game on the Mega Drive.
You can literally do whatever you want to me. Everybody
works on fault. I know, we thought they sucked ass. I preferred Wrestle War, and that were a great game at all.
Welcome to
Wrestle
Tap
you
War.
You just need to pin me. That's literally all you need to do. Every time you hit me, I'm down.
Maybe I need to hold on to it. Oh,
I think you have to press C and down or something stupid like that, or A and C together. I know.
What a wide taker.
I don't know why they always made pins so fucking awkward.
Come here.
Run after him at 5 frames per second.
That's begging for some action, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, but you can't do anything except roll and kick.
Oh!
The crowd are getting restless.
Yeah, because I picked up that fucking thing then. I was going to get counted out, though. I had a bit of that life.
Oh, the jerkiness of the screens. Give me a fucking headache, man.
Get away. Stop running. Spoilt it for the masses. I'm going to get counted out.
You should both get counted out. The elf could walk a bit faster.
Oh,
yes, there we are.
I was trying to get him with a bucket. That was my only saving grace.
He looks like he's going shopping. That looks like a shopping basket.
Jake the Snake going shopping. Well, that was a fucking bust.
I ain't playing that shit.
Nah, you know what? I don't even want to do a win
So, WWF Raw, is that a hit or a bust then, guys?
That was a bastardised version of anything.
It's no fucking WrestleFest, is it? Let's face it. And WrestleFest is the standard by which all wrestling games should ever be measured. So, let's give it another whirl then. Let's see. Let's look at some of the better games on there then. So, jump in there, Tone. Press A. Oh, have you got player 2's controller?
Oh, it's all on
It's
got to
be Mikey then. Mike's...
I'm going to provide my toilet services.
Oh, there's always one has to run off for a piss, isn't there? It's got a child's bladder, this one.
I'm going to nick your fag.
That's it. And again. So, the better games on here... We've already looked at Doom. Doom's a good one. You talked about Star Wars Arcade. Do you want to give that a whirl?
Go on and give that a spin.
So this is, even though it was like called up to 1996, this isn't Star Wars Trilogy Arcade, which is obviously the really well-renowned, funky one with the analog stick where the lightsaber battles and that. But yeah. It kind of fuses 95 technology with the original Star Wars Arcade, doesn't it?
I've never played it.
You've never played this one?
No. But is it the same as the one on the Mega CD? Because that was shit.
No. That was a different thing completely. Okay. This was... You play the original Star Wars Arcade, and you like the vector graphics and that. It's basically an enhancement of that, brought up to date.
Oh, I've got fond memories of it.
Actual polygon graphics.
nice speedy Sega logo.
No, yeah. See, it did add a few tricks. It could do some pretty good games. You know, it had better polygon processing than obviously the Mega Drive had.
You got surprised.
Scaling effects that the SNES had.
Because you still get people making Mega Drive games now. I mean, like the big one that I suppose most people know is Pierre Solar.
Yeah.
I wonder why nobody ever bothers making a 32X game that we should have had, perhaps.
Well, Bill here says to try Metalhead. He says Metalhead's got funny faces talking at the beginning, so I'll give that a try after this one.
It's like a MechWarrior type game, isn't it, I think.
MechWarrior, I've never seen it. So you've got like 32X. Enhanced, and yeah, that's it. So you got nice for the time. Those are nice polygons, you know. And it's moving.
Well, you've got to think the NES was doing that anyway.
Well,
the SNES.
The SNES, yeah, the SNES did it, but it didn't scale them at that speed. You know, you needed the Super FX chip to do it. Wipe out enemy
fighter. The sound's shit.
It's a trap. You know, this moves at a fair pace.
Proper controls.
The inverted
flight
controls.
Thank you.
Oh, what?
I was just
looking
the worst
in. This looks quite good, actually.
It's a good game. It's a very good game. It's one of the best ones on here.
Slow down.
I look to slow down. I can't answer it.
Moving fucking warp speed into asteroids and shit.
I love to slow down.
The music's a bit pants, but the sound effects are more right.
It's really tinny.
Hello?
To be honest, I think a little bit of that RF interference is coming into play there, but it's all right. But it's moving at a fair pace, you know. It's not slowing down when there's a lot of stuff on screen, is it? You know.
It looks nice.
Is that how much it is for this game, or you want to
know? I've got the console.
32X. Yes and no. I mean, as a curiosity, I mean, there's some rare systems I like purely for the rarity. And you know what? If you are a Sega fan, you know, I don't see. I mean, there's a couple of good games on here, you know.
Yeah, but the price is giving that on them then. Is it worth it for a couple of?
It is spiking. Yeah, it tends to be going up and down a bit. I mean,
the thing is, like, you'd have to get one of them ever drives. Because the game is going to be too much.
The game prices are ridiculous, but at least when you do get it, you got all the games there, you know. Yeah. I don't feel guilty about it on systems where getting the games is near impossible.
Yeah, if I bought the 32X, I'd never drive free. I wouldn't even piss about trying to get the games.
And of course, this is just the Mega Everdrive, so obviously it works for the Mega Drive games and the 32X games. So.
The Mega CD games as well?
Not yet. They're looking to do it in a future version, they hope. But because of the way they interface together, they don't know if it's going to be possible.
Would you have been happy if they'd have just stopped at the Mega CD, like not done the 32X and waiting for the Saturn?
I'd have been happy if they'd have stopped at the Mega Drive, to be honest.
Have missed out on the Saturn?
No, we still on the Mega CD.
Missed out on everything, just stay in the Mega Drive. Nothing else stinks.
Yeah, just put it on the Saturn. There's no need for any of that bullshit. Putting it on life support, look at all the wires coming out of that.
I know, it's too much, that is. So I was thinking about getting one, then I see the price and I thought, you know what?
Well, I've concealed the wiring thing quite well there. I'm just going to dip behind the back here just to show you again. So, you've got three separate power adapters. So, you've got a power adapter going into the Mega CD at the bottom there. You've got a power adapter going to the Mega Drive. And then you've got another one for the 32X. I think that was a massive overkill. They've got to be able to work out something better than that. Then you've got a jumper cable which goes from the Mega Drive into the 32X. Because the Mega Drive does handle some of the graphics. I think it draws the backgrounds or something.
Yeah, you can't. You don't plug it in and set it up right. You'll get the game to load, but there'll be graphics missing.
That's it, yeah. There's no foreground graphics, is there? And then obviously the extra sound channels are handled by the 32X as well. And then, of course, you've got the cable coming out. But, of course, back in the day, you'd had three separate power adapters. We're running it with one, which runs on a splitter, which is a lot better for, like, modern use. But
splitter!
We're the
Judean
people
scrum.
Fuck off!
Split.
We're the people
fighting Judea. How you getting on,
town?
You doing alright?
Getting on. Still don't really know what's
Watch out for
that
Star Destroyers!
I think the speed's automatic again.
I think you can slow down.
I can't.
Pull down. Hold A.
If you really
I can hear different
You need six.
Oh yeah, eyes like a break, innit?
Yeah. Who needs a fucking break? You know you brake on Ridge Racer?
Where are we going? We need no brakes.
We don't need brakes. Look at the intensity in his face. Look at that concentration.
You're not missing out, Tony's.
Look at the concentration.
Oh, no. That's a game face.
There's a bead of sweat coming down there, look.
Symbiosis of man and machine. Daryl. Daryl on pole position.
Getting hooked though, so it shows that the game's got some pull because you're sticking with it, like.
I would have fucking loved this in the 90s.
Yeah, definitely.
How much were the games back in the day?
It'd be like 40, 50 quid easy.
That was same as top end Mega Drive games.
Yeah.
People talk about game prices a lot, and I've heard people saying that adjusted for inflation, like the 16-bit era, they reckon that like the game prices there would be about 100 quid and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, even up to the PlayStation, I mean, I remember buying Space Hulk on the PS1 when it first came out, so maybe a bit after, 96, and I paid 45 quid for it. 45 quid,
fucking
nearly
hell.
20 years ago.
Wouldn't, like say, 50 quid back then equate to about 100 quid?
That's what I'm saying, the reckon for inflation, but I think it's a weird thing because I think it was like, I mean, even with the NES, when the NES came out, I remember NES games. I remember paying 20 quid for a typical NES game, and I think it was 35 for like when Super Mario 3 came out. It's like the very end of its life cycle. But then like that price of 40 quid tended to be the price for like throughout the 16-bit era. 40 quid was like the typical price,
yeah.
Apart from a few budget titles or lesser known ones.
Or when Virtual Racing came out.
Well, that was a special exception. It's like when Street Fighter 2 first went for SNES at 60 quid, everyone was like, 60 fucking quid?
Do you think, you know, like their games on there, the massive fucking games, it's like, some of them, like, you got to pay for like 20 hours, 200 hours, fucking whatever. Like, Mega Drive games, comparatively, quite small.
Yeah.
But they'd have been 60 quid. Do you think you was getting more for your money then or now?
See, that's a hard question, man. I've talked about this a lot with people, and it's like, because when you talk to anybody who's like a noob, yeah, and they weren't there back in the day, they're like, well, you paid loads of money for what were basic games. Even people were trying to defend the price of modern games and that. And I'm like, yeah, but the expectations back then, it's all about expectations of the time. And back then, yeah, you know, this was top end for the time. And so it was good value. And the difference whenever people try and draw a comparison, like I'm moan about modern gaming. I hate modern gaming's business model. I hate the way they have launch day specials and they're throwing all kinds of trinkets to try and have you buy stuff. And then you've got your fucking hat collections and DLC, which I cannot stand. And people say, oh, you get more value for money and adjusted for inflation, you're paying about the same as you did back then for a console game. Like, yeah, but the difference was these games were refined to a point where they had to be tip-top when they came out on cartridge. Because there was no way to update it.
Yeah,
there was no way to add content. And if DLC was known as a sequel, that was how you did a new content. You made a fucking sequel. And back then, you bought a game, you owned it. You got a physical cartridge. All those cartridges you got down there, you bought them, you owned them.
That was a complete game.
A complete game. And that's the big fucking difference. Just because they look primitive by today's standards, you know, it's not just rose-tinted specs. They were more refined games for the era. They pushed the boundaries. They made the very best game they could. You know, and okay, there were some rush games and stuff, but, you know, the A-plus titles of the time hold up today because so much refinement went into them. And when you've got the finished product, you've got the finished product. It weren't released as a patched fucking beta or...
Well, the new Fallout has come out. Bethesda put out a thing the other day, well, it was like last week or the week before. Basically, if you read it the way it is, it's them basically saying, look, it's going to be a bag of shit on release. That's basically what they said, in nicer words, but there was like, thank you for sticking with us and this, that and the other. And they basically said, this is going to be a bag of shit that we're going to have to keep updating all the time. So why not hold it back longer till it's not going to be a bag of shit?
And yet the production times are longer than ever.
Yeah.
You know, the teams are bigger than ever, the costs are bigger than ever. And I'm like, I can't understand it because They're not coming out with anything original, and I wouldn't mind, but a lot of games now are all using the same fucking engines. No one's innovating.
Do you think it's more for the technology that's being used because it's all open world, internet based? Because that yeah. is Fallout 76 is basically an internet based game. It's not like this, so you're playing a game when you're on a campaign and this.
Like, yeah,
it's,
yeah.
It's open source.
Well, that's what I mean. The very nature of gaming has changed, and you've got games now where you're dependent on this online thing for it to even be a game, and I don't like that because
I think
it means
more games are going to go that way as well.
It will, and the problem is that once that the interest dies off, that game as a game is dead.
Yeah, it dies.
It dies with it. It dies with the era passing. The servers have already gone down for like PS3s and Xbox 360.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's some games on there where beyond the online stuff, there's no game.
Well, these games are going to last forever.
That's right, and not forgetting, if you download a game that is incomplete from the start.
You don't like that one?
No, I just couldn't do the mission.
It's your choice.
It's my choice again.
Yeah.
Turn that off then, mate.
Okay.
Well, that gets a thumbs up from me.
It's a good
yeah,
game,
that was.
Have you played the Star Wars Cabot Arcade Club? You sit in it and
the cockpit version of the original.
Yeah.
Is the Vector
yeah.
one? Oh, man.
Yeah.
That was one of the first arcade machines. It was that. There's three that all the real soft spot in my heart. Is that
which
one
you looking for, you reckon?
The USA one.
December the 8th, Saturday. I'm thinking about going to arcade clubs for my birthday, so.
Oh, man, look. Yeah, yeah.
If you have
that. What day that land on?
Saturday.
It will run, mate.
Oh, none of them will run?
No.
Because Albion and playing Villa on the Friday.
Get back.
B,
on Saturday. So now I've got all weekend free, so I'll be at the Albion on the Friday.
What up for that, yeah.
Hang on, have I done it again?
If you want to come to that as well,
yeah.
Craig, if you fancy
which
it.
Which one's what? Oh, you're
yeah, but we'll do soon, mate. We'll do.
Okay, I'm here.
You're in on
the road. Do you want to try
that? I don't hear anything you said.
You're in general, my bad.
Try that metalhead.
No. Yeah, go on.
Okay, club, you prick.
December the 8th?
Yeah, it's Saturday.
No,
for it, Craig, you and the
missus. I might very well be. I know I'm doing a few things towards Christmas, but I'll definitely give that a try.
What do you want,
Tom? Try Metalhead. Bill mentioned there's some funny things to look at on there. So.
Metalhead.
It's all on Bill now, then. It's not
funny.
Is
but,
it in the V's? Metal Mickey loves Metalhead, then.
I remember
Metal
Mickey,
yeah.
That robot, but I don't remember
what
he was from.
No, there's a character in the V's.
Metal
Mickey?
Yes, I do.
You know which one
I want to be? Yeah, I do, yeah. I've never seen this game, so I don't know what's involved.
Even though I never had a 32X, I brought a bulk load of shit off somebody, and I'd got this on cartridge. So I own this game, but I've never played it.
Ah, there you go.
What, 32X cartridge?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Soldy.
But you sold all your main drive stuff?
And all my NES stuff, and all my SNES stuff.
Well, you know that main drive portrayal you keep whacking? Do you know what I mean?
Is that the one Jenny dropped?
Yeah, they dropped fucking all. They dropped everything in this house.
So this is a mech game.
I wear Oxalica.
I remember this, actually.
Oh, my God. You know what that reminds me of?
Yes.
No, you've played Street Fighter 1. Have you heard the speech on that?
The graphics are nice,
eh? I mean, it's processing well.
You ever play a game called Lost Planet? It's a bit like that.
No.
Never played Lost Planet, the Xbox? Great game.
Oh!
Very arcadey.
I've
got these mech warrior things. But you're like a standalone bloke.
Yeah.
And he'd jump into them as well.
It's a Capcom game, I think.
Yeah.
The Japanese, they're mad for these fucking
the
mech games.
It's Gundam, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gundam, they love that shit.
So let's see what this is all about then. I've never seen this.
Us round, I ain't got the Gundam stuff down.
That's a big genre.
Too many menus, man. The Japanese,
they
fucking
love menus. They love their menus.
My eyes are too round.
I can't see too much on the screen.
Oh, as is Gran Turismo.
Gran Turismo.
Oh my God.
Someone's having a fit.
That's horrible.
The fuck is that?
Whose design idea was that?
You've got three frames of animation, do your best.
But Bill did say they were funny. Fucking he's right.
Yeah, fair play, Bill. Him right.
He looked like, what was his name now? Is it the 80s blonde Mr.
Max Headroom.
Max Headroom.
That's who fucking looked like him.
All that music is tinny, isn't it?
That sounds like someone off a Game Boy.
It does. I've got to be honest, I think my 32X might need a little bit of a service. So I did have to clean it to get it working not long ago, so I had to clean it inside and out, like the contacts are.
This reminds me a bit of Iron Soldier.
I was going to say that, on the Jaguar. Yeah.
That ain't a good thing when games are reminding you of Jaguar games.
But you know what, if you like mech stuff, you're probably going to kick out of this, wouldn't you?
If you got really straight hair and slanty eyes, you'll love it. Other than that, it's a bit shit. What's that yellow fucking thing keep flashing at me?
What?
There
we go. He's going to fuck you up.
I think
he might. He's trying to talk to you, but he's mumbling like fuck.
So he did say, please help me.
You know, I mean, with a 6-point joypad, there may be a way to look up and down and stuff, but
I'll bring your Sega Collection controller.
It's just the inferior quality of your collection. You're just killing the experience for everybody.
It's just a massive buzzkill.
Yeah. You're all welcome to fuck off.
Don't invite me around again.
Yeah, your controllers aren't up to task.
Yeah, it's alright. Yeah,
anybody want
to play? Let's try that fucking the next thing.
Right, yeah, we'll move on to that now then. So
I'm excited about that because I've never seen one.
Right, okay, so, okay, yeah. Kill that. So, piss break for town. So, 32X then. Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Middle of the road.
Down!
See, so proper mixed bag.
So, up, down, and in the middle, so
up,
that
down,
averages
left, right.
Really.
Shake it all about.
Yeah.
It's something that I want to really lust after. I want to lust after it because it's Sega, but other than that. If that was Nintendo,
you want it because it's Sega.
Yeah.
You don't want it for any other reason.
If Nintendo or any other fucking game fucking developer or whatever, I would not fucking have that.
No.
I mean, there are some good games there. We're playing Doom. Well, quite well there.
But again, why would you choose? Because Doom's been on everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Why would you choose to play it on a 32X?
Platform exclusives. You'd need to mod your system. And then Calibri is one of the best.
Calibri,
ones.
Calibri, Sonic, Knuckles, Chaos. That's it.
There's a couple of good titles.
That Star Wars one's alright.
Star Wars is good. Yeah. So I mean, if you're Sega fan,
Raw
was bore.
I was alright with Raw.
Yeah, but what Max wants to say apart from the Mega Drive? That game, no. Nothing.
No, I've got wrestling games for Mega Drive that are a lot better.
Exactly.
I'm not going to fucking...
I never got the wrestling thing, even as a kid. Never got into it.
Oh, yeah, I was a massive wrestling fan.
There was two things. One, I thought it was really childish, and even as a kid, I could tell it was fake. And I'd argue with the other kids at school, like, no, it is definitely fake.
Yeah, but nobody said it was real. Well, people do say
it's real.
No, they
didn't.
It's like theatre.
Yeah, I could understand it from that perspective now, but back in the day... And there was something a bit weird about enjoying watching big, oily men touch each other.
But now you try and touch Craig all the time.
No, I don't try, I succeed.
Right then, so moving on, we're on to our third of our little trio of things now. And I'm going to need some assistance as it's on you. Right, so just kick the kick.
Did you hear him? He said kick.
Move.
He said kick.
Need the Mega Drive joypads. Right, so this is what we're looking at now, right? This is the Mega Drive X, right? Now, the Mega Drive X, there's not a lot of love out there for clone consoles in general, but there's a good reason why I want to talk about this one. You need to sort that out, cheers, man. The Mega Drive X itself, it's had three or four different revisions, and it does suffer from the same problems that all clone consoles do.
Do you want to turn it on yet?
Not just yet. It's basically, it's a system on a chip in there. Now, if you know anything about clones, back in the day, clone systems would have been one-to-one hardware clones, so they would have had all the same chips copied over, so it would be almost identical. So... like these, you know the Scorpion, the Mega Drive, you know the Scorpion system, have you ever seen that? It was a clone made back in the day, Scorpion 16, I think they called it. It looked a bit like a Mega Drive, and it had the proper edge connector, so you can connect it to a Mega CD and everything. And it was like, they did a feature on it on bad influence, because they were talking about piracy and stuff like that. And they were saying that Sega were finding it hard to ban sales. I think it was popular in Russia and other places like that. But anyway, modern clones, obviously, because we can do things simpler now, modern clones use system on a chip, so you'd have like one low-grade chip that handles everything from the graphics, the sound, you know, the controller processing and things like that. And they're regarded as crap because they don't output the same kind of quality, you lose features, and...
Do you feel like you're being fucking lectured to from the pulpit? The way you're standing up there just talking at us.
I'm religious, I'm used to it.
Should we get some fucking robes or something?
It's AL4 and brimstone yet, so I'm alright with it.
Yeah.
But yeah, anyway, so clown consoles generally. I mean, you've played anything that Blaze at Games have done?
We talked about that today on the podcast today, and because we were on about the PlayStation Mini, and he said, has Sega ever done anything like that? I said, not personally, Sega themselves. Yeah. Well, there's loads of Sega consoles, and they're all Sega clones from At Games, and they're all shit.
And they're all shit.
Everyone.
And it's because...
I've seen them advertised. I mean, Argos and everything, and they like...
Run. Just...
Well, they don't even use system on a chips. They use, like, basically some kind of, I think, some kind of ARM branch. And
sound the panic alarm.
The telly's about to turn itself off.
And obviously, that the big problem with At Games is the sound, isn't it? The sound,
it's awful.
It's off key. It's slow. It's really weird.
It's diabolical.
And a pain in the arse. Well,
some clever fucker reverse engineered the handheld one, the decent one with SD card slot, and they've sorted it out so you can put something onto the SD card, and I think it sorts the sound out. I haven't looked
into
it.
There are ways of doing it, yeah. I have got a couple of the handheld ones. I do quite like the handheld ones for the convenience, but
yeah,
they've all got common problems. Now, this is a newer clone. It's only been out in the last 5-6 years, I think this is.
Gizzy.
And anybody who knows, it's based on the shell of the Genesis 3, which we never got that over here. And that was an official Sega thing, but I think that was produced by... I think Tech Toy were the ones involved in producing that.
That's a Brazilian...
Yeah, because they still produce Sega consoles for the South American market, don't they? So, anyway... Yeah.
They love the Master System as well.
I know, I'll tell you what, because they got the new Mega Drive first as well.
Imagine the morning show. In the favelas, arguing out, shooting and robbing today. I'm playing next to the fucking kid.
So this system anyway, it looks like a Genesis 3. But it's got a few little trick ports. I mean, obviously, you've got standard AV out, which is very similar to the Mega Drive 2 output, but it's not identical. It's got lower power consumption, but the real trick is what's on the bottom. You've got a few switches on the bottom there. You can see it's basically a pre-modded Mega Drive. So you've got the language selection on the bottom. You've got the 50-60 hertz selection on the bottom between NTSC and PAL. And there's also an overclock switch, and what that does is it doesn't overclock the system fully. What it does is it eliminates, so you don't speed up the games. What it does do is it eliminates things like slowdown on games where you've got a lot of action on screen. And if we fire up Sonic, you'll be able to see that. So I'm going to set this to what we would normally get over here, which is UK language PAL. 50 hertz and standard. Yeah, you ain't got much slack. No, don't. This is only a cheap thing anyway. So,
how much do they go for now? Can you still get them?
These, yeah. There's been a few revisions and the board's slightly different inside, but I think I paid for this. I think it's 35 quid.
Job in the town.
That's not right.
That's 35 quid for like a new Mega Drive. It's not bad. And when you see, I mean, performance-wise, not bad. I mean, you've got 6-button pads as standard, and they're not bad pads, you know what I mean? There's a lot worse pads out there than these. You've got the mode switch, you've got the turbo fire switch.
And it's the proper 9-pin
proper 9-pin connector, well, yeah. So these do work with the standard Mega Drive, and you can use standard Mega Drive pads with it as well.
If you've got, like, just shitty 3-button joy pads and you invite people around to play, you want to give them the 6-button experience.
I can't wait to fucking... I'm going to buy another one of them and beat it to fucking death with it.
Well, there is one catch, of course, is that you'll notice the length of the wires is short.
But it ain't black and got a red button.
As well. You know, it's got 4 red buttons.
It's all black.
That's true.
Black dog crack.
Yes.
So we'll fire this up. This is.
A lot tread on it, in a bit, we'll see.
On our gender, no, it's fine.
So this is standard PAL. And you might notice a slight reduction in the sound quality because the aerial lead's not as good.
You can do a verse if you want.
And I think this is in 50 hertz mode. I think.
Do a big screen first.
Yeah, do a big screen.
Do you see how quickly you can complete the first level? Oh, he's seen forward and he's
seen. Oh, it's getting serious now, look.
Come on. Quite a blue.
Even fog. Tails is calling you a wanker.
Yeah, well, he's not like you either.
Oh, checking I said this right, actually. I think it's in...
feels really sluggish.
It does feel... I think this is how it's supposed to be. I thought the music would be slower on PAL, though. I might be thinking of Sonic 1.
Sonic 1's got the slower music.
Yeah, I should have showed that. Have you got Sonic 1 here?
I'll give that away.
Oh, you know what? I've got it on the Everdrive. I'll compare it on the Everdrive in a sec. But
I started off some guitarist daughter's collection with that. Oh, suck your mom.
But like,
wish Big Mike we can forgive the first one. Come on, visit here. Yeah. Press reset.
Fully one, shame on you.
He won't do it on Sonic 1 though. He knows you won't fuck me with that. Even when you little fucking.
How long was that? 35 seconds, was that?
35 exactly. Yeah, watch me fucking die here.
I have hit that spring 6 times.
Concentration.
You twat!
Like that affected anything.
You nasty bag of washing. I'd never do that.
Nasty bag of washing. See, I did exactly that. Hit that fucking thing. Yeah, you've got this. Unless somebody was to pull the controller out.
Bastard!
Oh, it's gonna get there to the wire. I don't know, you can do that on this one. I've got a
drama.
Drama. Oh! It's gonna get there to the wire.
Oh,
2 seconds. 3 seconds.
34, I got prick.
35.
What the fucking bitch asshole.
You have goo?
I'm gonna score nothing on this.
Tony's gonna smash it now, what?
No, I'm not.
As long as it beats your air bubble, show you up.
Yeah, just make sure you don't hit the spring twice.
I'm gonna hit everything here, I haven't played this for a
minute. I'm gonna hit it all twice in a minute.
92.
Start.
Do you have any of the cheats there?
92.
Hello, missus. The missus has just checked in.
I'm not back.
That was very simultaneously.
Well, yeah, but you only
did
one
star,
mate.
It felt so...
Oh, no. Tony's fucked him already.
That's it. You're blowing it, mate. You choked.
Tony's fucked
him.
He's still might be part time, though.
Nah. You fucked it.
No. I want another crack at this.
Oh no, no second chances here.
That's it, mate, done now.
Well, let's lay loose to the Nintendo. Well, he's getting extra. Yeah, I was just doing the missions, nah.
You know the Chaos Emerald before this, so.
He's nearly got 50 rings.
Oh, he's also got 50 seconds on the clock.
True.
What you gonna now? Run away.
Very good, very
not bad.
Wow.
I'll be in a minute.
You're just going to try and redeem yourself on that one.
I ain't going to have a second gear even if you beat me because I ain't a fucking child.
Thank God, you spent like a month trying to beat my time.
I did.
I'm Sonic 1, you should spend like a month trying to beat my time. Fuck you, Tails, nobody likes you.
If he doesn't land on something here. Oh, I knew that was going to happen.
But he timed that and he did exactly the same. He got away with it. Fucking prick.
You calling shenanigans?
I'm calling something. Fuck you.
Well recovered. Oh, almost. I'd say that's all over, mate.
Oh, fuck you. Where's my fucking
35 again?
You know what? I'd have got fucking 32 if I had to come backwards then. Bitch ass punk motherfucker.
You suck. But well done.
Yeah.
So anyway, you can see like the script.
Extra life.
The picture quality and everything's pretty mint, isn't it? Like, I mean, that's better than some of the pictures you get from Mega Drives now because they're fading. The sound and everything's passable. The controller's alright, isn't it?
Controllers are great.
I mean, I heard you like complain. I mean, I've seen some shit. They ain't top quality, but
I really like the controller.
I feel like I'm pressing through the pad with this stuff.
A bit lighter, or flimsy like.
Yeah.
I think the six button pads always felt a bit flimsy anyway.
It's like the third party six button joypad I've got.
Yeah.
And I really like that. You can get like You can get them on eBay now for like fucking under a tenner, and they're alright.
Peanuts, yeah. I mean, it's ain't bad, there's things going out. At least this one's actually got the mower button, so you can switch between 6 button and 3 button for the games that you need to do it on.
I'm gone.
But I'll show you what the difference makes in a set to some of the games. I'll put the overdrive back in and we'll show you what the difference will be on Sonic.
We don't need this.
No, I'll let you beat him. Redeem yourself.
I did.
You know, at least kick Robotnik's ass. And it is Robotnik, not fucking Eggman.
Where you bitch? What time are you using a cunt?
See, Az could have joined in and helped you, but he didn't.
Because he's a useless cunt at all.
This is all true.
Hey, there we go. So, someone do the honours. Just turn that off and put the Everdrive in.
Yep, right. It's my fucking day off. I'm here to play games and relax.
I'm here to kick ass and chew bubblegum.
Yeah.
And I'm all out of gum.
All out of gum.
So that is actually a better picture than what we were getting just through the real thing. Load up Sonic 1, please, mate.
Oh, let's do this thing.
Let's keep pressing right, I see, yeah.
Hang on, I forgot the last name.
There you go.
Any particular one?
Sonic 1 SMD, that one.
Don't want to get away with you.
And this should, if I've got the settings set right on the bottom of the Mega Drive X.
I want to chase. I like score chasing.
This sounds fast.
This should be slow. We'll see. No, I don't think it affects that. It's the music. There we go.
Oh, it's slow as fuck.
That is proper PAL version Sonic. Ooh, it's painful to listen to.
Slow. Is the game slow as well?
It is. What it was, there was no reason any port should ever have been slower, even if it was 50 hertz. All they needed to do was adjust the coding to make it move faster and adjust the pitch of the music. But they were lazy back in the day and they never did it in the early games. Like today, if you were to do that, you'd never get away with it.
Fuck! Oh, I thought there was a spring there.
The lack of like sympathy there.
Zero compassion.
So 33 seconds. So just press start. Like. There you go. Load straight back up.
On fucking silence from you, Gimp.
He was pushing my hand when it was my turn.
Yeah, well, I was trying to get T-cock.
Tickle his balls.
That's so slow.
Yeah, but that's, but you know what? That's how we had it. Forget, but that's exactly how we had it.
Mike's here. He actually sent me a message when he got Sonic back for the Mega Drive.
No, stopped. People worry. I was playing it on my phone.
I was playing it on your phone. Oh, that's right. You was playing it on your phone. You said it was really quick. Or you was playing it on your Mega Drive. You said it was really slow. I said, no, that's just we were used to it being that way back in the day. We forgot. The spring there.
No, there isn't. Are you fucking done?
What was your time?
33.
Oh!
Can we play on the real fast fucking?
Yeah, that's exactly what we're gonna do now. If you just hold that for a second, please.
And then what we'll do is we'll kill that. We'll crank
that's
it.
Dead.
What?
No, just kill that. Sorry, I'm doing a Bob Mills in bed.
Oh, okay. So we turn that up now, we'll switch it to 60 Hz, we'll switch it to US region, will this auto switch to NTSC TV?
We'll have a look.
And we'll put up, we'll turn overclock on as well.
We'll see.
If not, it's going to be black and white. I bet you're attending, it's black and white because the Dreamcast uses.
And Japanese text.
Random auto is all.
Press start. Now press start. Fine then, now are we?
Come on.
I'm still on PAL mode. Oh, you know, I'll probably need to reload the ROM, so press.
Go on, do you go?
I'll go, yeah.
Oh, catch up.
Shh, shh, shh. No, it is in colour. It has switched.
Look at all the precious things from the shop.
Oh,
131. Okay. It's all
for sale. Is it?
£2.50 for the lot.
I'll give you a quid.
No.
No. It's a swing version.
It's like you and our brother have sex.
Horrible, yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Horrible and slow, you've never had anybody fucking slow as him. I can last 2 hours now, you call, you just ain't even getting any friction.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you know.
That's more like it.
That's like Mike having sex.
Right.
Fucking it's over.
Now, since our Mike's supposed to be the master, let's see what happens with this.
Oh, I'm telling you, mate.
Yay!
Need to get you a sippy cup.
So now we're in 60 hertz, and I've killed... I put the hour clock on as well. So if you lose your rings, it should process faster.
Whoa.
Oh, hang on. I've hit the wrong switches here.
I'm sorry, that's the underclock switch.
You know what it is? I think I've set the region mode wrong. Right, hold on a sec. We'll address this. We'll get this.
Wow, I've got one for a good fucking time here.
Nah, fuck it, turn it off. He's been for a good time.
Good time
there. He looks like a flick book.
Oh, we'll never know. That could have been the one.
That could have been like sub fucking 30. 24 was my best on that.
That should be right.
Was it 23?
I don't know, that's quite fast.
If I press start, we'll see. And then I'll reset it for you to start. Yeah, that's
yeah, whoa, fuck me.
Now, press start then.
That was like Sonic on Coke.
Yeah, now you'll see the difference.
This might make it harder because you've got to fucking.
Yeah, there's no slowdown at all. And if you lose your rings, you won't slow down because I put it on overclock mode. It doesn't actually speed up the pace, this is just 60 hertz speed. We oh. Said like the screen didn't flip it to shit or anything because I've turned around the clock on.
Jump your blue cunt.
This is proper speed, Sonny. This sucks that we never got it at this speed, you know what I mean?
I've got a shit time now.
It ain't that bad. 34.
I've already beat you.
No,
you've
got to beat me.
No, you've got to beat me. I've already beat him.
Yeah, but this is 60 hertz mode.
Yeah,
it's 60 hertz. This is 60 hertz mode. It's all pace and different.
I could get quicker, but I don't.
Tell you what, London, I'll get up my fucking spill. Cause yeah. It's
until somebody beats me, I don't need to try to get there.
I'll beat him with a fucking stick in a minute.
Tony's up. Pressure's on. His first run, and he's on the fast mode.
Don't expect anything out of this.
You never know.
How long has it been since I last played this game?
1991.
Yeah, long time ago. It was a very good Christmas for me, that was, and then.
You know, Sonic 1, good game, but it was missing one crucial thing.
The spin.
Yep.
Yeah.
Without the spin, you couldn't get the speed up, and the level design made it a pain in the ring.
Was that the thing that they added to the second one to make it more updated?
Yeah, I suppose it was.
We've made it a better game.
He's doing right, he's pulling it back.
I'm going to give it 37 now.
Go on, Tom, fucking speed up, fucking show him. Fucking show him, son.
I said 37.
You were right.
Weren't bad. 37 for Tom. Go on, how's you up?
I ain't, no need to.
You're doing it?
I've already got 35. On the man,
you know what it is?
On the man to beat.
He's scared to get a sheet of time, that's what it is.
On the faster speed. We'll soon see.
Yeah, put it. 20 seconds off my time for the faster speed.
Right, no pressure. Oh, he knows a little tricks, look.
Fuck you, you son of a bitch.
But you've got that slow down on there now.
Hey!
Fucked it. Completely fucked that.
Third time lucky. Third time lucky.
Fucked it.
Yeah, fucked it.
I wish we could play that then, because it would have been worse than my time. The second time I played the game in about 20 years.
I never knew you was this competitive, Mark.
It's just brilliant, I love it.
It's a game it's all about.
You missed it, he's already fucked it. He's going to get intimate with that reset button, isn't he?
I'll be pressing that more than I've pressed any button in my life.
Respectable
time. Still got
34, not bad.
I could have got fucking so much better, but I.
If you had to be flat, one fuck up, you'd be
quite yeah. Fuck you, but I died, you know.
You didn't, mate.
That's the truth, I'm fucking mad, I fucking died, you know.
So. Not a bad little console, then, is it, really?
I'm considering getting one then. Yeah,
I mean, it's pretty robust. The picture quality is top end, you know what I mean? That is really sharp. And like I say, adding in their little features. Got a few other little tricks as well, which are... I mean, obviously, people who've seen this before, this is now a surprise. But if you load up Streets of Rage, please.
Have a bit of that.
I'm going to hit the mother load. You won't touch my fucking gold.
No, don't. Oh yeah, if you ever play Streets of Rage, Mike, don't bother going for the gold and the money bags.
Oh, I like gold.
He'll just beat you up.
Yeah, you need to reset again. Press start.
Oh,
press
yes. See us. Fanny.
Soz. Force of habit, are you? Try yeah. To get them 32 seconds.
Press A. That's 6 of ROMs. There we go. That's it, Streets of Rage 1, that's it, loaded stuff.
I ain't fucking with any other Streets of Rage.
Arguably the best soundtrack of any game.
It is.
And a lot of people who talk about Streets of Rage 2 being better, I still maintain it.
The soundtrack definitely not better.
Right, don't press star or anything.
I never do on these.
And obviously on this, if you want to hold the thing on the screen, if we flip this during gameplay, and I go down to, that should in a second. There we go. Change the Japanese text.
Wow, halfway through?
Yeah.
What? You flip the switch?
Yeah, I'll flip the switch to Japanese language. He switches it halfway through when he gets us his damn round noise.
Damn round, coming over on you, raging our streets. If you wait for the title screen to come on,
yeah.
Will it switch to Bare Knuckle and then back to the Streets of Rage?
It'll switch to Bare, yeah, press start to go to.
Fuck me.
Grand Motorismo!
No, press start. And just go straight to it this time. It should come up Bare Knuckle straight away.
Bare Knuckle!
There you go, Bare Knuckle cool. Straight away. But if you let it run to.
Twat.
Don't matter. I want to say if you let it run to demo and go back, it should switch back to Streets of Rage. But anyway.
What are we doing? Two players or one?
Oh, Tony can play me. I don't like playing me. You get too competitive.
But again, I'm going to start it as PAL. And then I'll switch it live to 60 Hz.
Craig, pass Tony the other joint, by the way.
Yeah.
Do you see what I sat that to as well?
Hard, I imagine.
Hardest.
Hardest.
Come on now. Don't take me for some premature ejaculator.
Yeah, slow it is.
It's how that's on the main drive though, isn't it?
It is.
It's how.
It is. You just forget how slow it is. Seriously, that is how slow.
Now, I'll tell you what, after we've done all this, I'll put it on. I bet you it's how that's slow.
Oh, yeah. This is how I remember it.
It's how that's slow.
I don't remember it being that slow.
No, it's
how
that's slow.
Mine had already done a bit of that. I've got the clock switch on. That could be one.
Yeah, you're pressing A already, Tom.
Is that another?
Yeah.
Just being seen of everything on this.
The music might not be quite that slow, but the actual action is.
Yeah, the action is actually the music, eh? Yeah. Yeah, the gameplay is exactly the same.
If I flip this back up now. There we go.
That's the stuff.
There we go. Just on the dreams. That's what it's made of. And you've got overclock on as well, so it should be now slowed down and only the segments where you do the game. Like we've got shit loud on the screen. Or you know the accent, where the accent grabs up, it slows down. It won't slow down anymore.
Yeah,
sounded down like getting fisted.
That's what he's like when you go for the gold.
Oh boy, mate.
Fuck off.
You both with the wrong character anyway.
No chance. Nah, I'd never be Adam. Whoa! Get fucked up here. Always Axel.
You got bitch slap.
He always gets up really quick. You talk about it, you can always get him. Fuck you. Whoa! You ain't branding him now. I like the way you can do this as well. You can grab him. And then like, what? You can like, oh fuck you. You're getting that. You can like grab him, hit him, then turn away and grab him quickly again.
That's what you have to do with the fat man, eh? To get like a rhythm.
Now what I do is I get the fat man in the corner and just jab him twice. Just keep jabbing him twice. That's what you have to do.
Well, so you have to use awful street boys from the 16. Let me know what you think about the 16, 6 foot pads.
For an ass kicking on Street Fighter, Mike.
Which one's playing?
Two.
What's happening?
Let's see.
Oh!
Drama!
Drama!
Press no, press that one again. Press A. That's it, ROMs.
Yeah, if anyone who doesn't know, the reason it did what we were showing there is because Mega Drive ROMs generally contain all three regions on every cartridge. You can do that with original cartridges, not just with the Everdrives. You switch it midway and it will switch between because the Japanese version of the ROM is still on that cartridge. So when you switch it over, it just accesses the Japanese version of the ROM.
A good thing as well, I don't know whether anybody's aware, because I play my Xbox 360 a lot and I've downloaded shitloads off the marketplace because the Xbox marketplace is brilliant. There's a Sega collection split into games of three, like the Street Rage 1, 2, 3, go on Xbox.
Oh, the Mega Collections.
Yeah, and there's Alex Kidd, Wonder Boy, and stuff like that. On all of them, you can go into the options and change all the regions, change all the language settings as well. Oh, hang on.
Yeah, because this is one of the few exceptions I was talking about. The later ones, which have got copy protection in, they actually started to remove the foreign version, so this will have to go in 50Hz mode. Just hold that and I'll switch it back to 50Hz.
Okay,
I think, you know what, I think we'll actually set the region to UK and then flick it up to 60Hz and it will run okay, so you might be able to hear it full speed still.
The good thing about the Mega Drive version is that you can whack the stars up to about 8 stars. So
yeah,
you can make
fast,
it faster.
That's what I always do anyway. I always play it on Hyper 14 fucking...
Super Turbo Nutter Bastard.
X.
French.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Right, now it's not.
The French version don't fight, they should all go backwards.
There you go.
Like I said, the difference is I think they adjusted all these anyway to be at the proper speed. They were coded properly. You still got to be letterboxing, obviously, because it's in 50Hz mode, but. Great game, but you know what? The fucking sound makes me want to tear my own fucking ears off.
Really?
It sucks. The speech. The speech is dreadful on the Mega Drive.
Oh,
it's crackly as fuck. Come on, Tone. Pull it back, mate. You'll remember what you'll come back to. That's instinctive.
Oh, I had a terrible time last time I was there. Hang on, hang on. What the buns? Hang on, hang on.
Oh, shit.
Hang on. Hold on.
Fuck you.
That's the spirit of sportsmanship right there from Mike. Pissed off that he failed at his game, Sonic, against Aaron, the underdog. He's now trying to take his anger out on Tony, who hasn't played it and doesn't know his fucking controls.
That's the way game is.
I think my shorts was lighter than ever. Is it just going across?
No retreat, no surrender.
Change your buttons if you want.
No, it's alright.
Change your mind.
What is it by default? It's hard on the left or the right?
Well, I have it on the left, so I presume it's on the right.
Oh.
Yeah, it is.
What the fucking is that here?
Oh, here we go. The anger's coming in.
Terrible.
terrible.
Yeah, you know what? Don't show off the beaten path.
I'll turn my attack level down.
Right, yeah.
Light punch.
Oh, on the outside.
One jar, medium punch, hard punch, light kick, medium kick, hard kick. Oh,
that's what's now on the SNES is Luxy Rab, because that was the
yeah, anyway. Fucking cagey straight away, mate.
Oh, no, slow down there either. Look, I've got overclock on.
I can't play the old Street Fighters. Ah!
I've got
jump sweep to death.
Fucking hell. Annual player 2, so he's got the disadvantage on the dragon punches. As keep away tactics. As if you get trapped, don't forget the air hurricanes or someone turbo. There you go.
Side.
Oh,
that's the side you're stopping then.
I found his Achilles dick. Oh, look what's going on.
You needed that day, huh?
Yeah, I was stressing out, that was.
Hey, I'm not the only one who thinks that the sound is wank on the Mega Drive version. Right. Everyone's saying it's
tiny.
Mike's going to go away and lick his wounds now.
Oh, no, it's fair, everybody gets wailing.
Taz, he's got a fair chance now against Taz, because Taz ain't bitch.
Taz is going to go for that big fucking back kick.
I had my attack level down.
You know what? We should play versus, but no Shotos, no Ryu, no Ken, no Sagat.
Down to your thing, mate.
Press start. Thailand!
Blank is like the suckiest character on this.
Blanka? What? Blanka's good, man.
I like Blanka.
Tell you who's a good Blanka player, Woody. Play Woody again, Woody at Turbo on the arcade, you'll nail you, man.
Bam!
Oh shit! Oh shit!
He's coming back into the game.
Fucking hell! Yeah.
Tony's welcome.
Oh!
Blank has arrived.
Brazil!
Oh, you slag.
Fucking flash kick!
Oh!
Flash kick! Flash kick!
Flash kick!
Oh, is that gonna be you once?
Go! They're on their feet! It's getting serious! What speed turbo you got this on?
10?
4?
Fucking hell, man, I can't play at this speed.
Yeah, we have to play it 4. It's too slow, boys.
I used to run on 2.
Oh no, it's gonna be fucking 4.
I'd offer to play, but I really can't play on a controller not my hand anymore.
Obviously, it's really good. I got the arcade stick for the Mega Drive.
Okay.
Yeah.
I thought it was a Dreamcast one.
No, I've got a Mega Drive one.
Out of the corner?
Yeah.
It's a terribly ill arcade stick now. Terribly ill arcade stick now.
Yes!
He sat there quiet all this time.
We're too busy arguing.
Oh, no, yeah, he's fucking you up.
I needed that.
Right, now shot hours, now Ryu and Ken.
Oh, I'll say.
That'll be a pussy.
Wait, one in my house.
Oh, here we go. Improving Asian relations here, are we? India and Japan. Ken stage. Oh, you're picking all the shit stages, the crap music. Oh, yeah.
Down to your
slap. Oh, you know what we'll have to do a video on? I'm going to get Rich to bring his Virtual Boy again and we'll have Street Fighter 2 on the Virtual Boy.
That'll be good. I don't mind getting a date for a video.
Can't get close to you on that.
I am going to build an arcade stick for it.
Oh, well, fine.
Someone I know reckons it can build me a TV output for it as well.
Wow, that.
It just, you know, create the image from one of the lenses.
Oh, so it should be 2D one.
Yeah, yeah. Look, it wouldn't work for a lot of games, but a lot of games it would. Oh, bitch slapped.
It just cannot get close to him.
Fucking hell.
Just get close to him.
On the bounce.
Have you won a game yet?
Yeah, but your first game.
I don't think you did.
No, no, you won now.
I don't think you did.
Let's look at this. You know, Mikey shit at Street Fighter.
Oh, look what he's done. Look what he's done.
Bison.
Sonic Hell Crusher all the way.
Psycho Crusher.
To be fair, if he was on Champion Edition mode, yeah, I could say that's cheap because he's fucking, you'd be dead.
I'll go with Chun-Li just to
came to the speed.
Well, just to be this the Chinese thing.
So, Mike, so far, how many games have you lost at today? Sonic 1, Sonic 2, Street Fighter 2.
All of the games.
All of the games.
Crappy fucking consoles.
Oh, is it the console's fault, is it?
His name.
Get elbowed in the face. Psycho Crusher!
I don't know how to do.
Back for 2 seconds.
Forward and punch. Back for 2 seconds. Forward and kick for a scissor kick.
Nah,
it's everything. The excuse is coming out now.
Joypad's broke.
Batches are going.
Chun-Li's noise though. We can all agree on that.
Yeah.
Oh, Chun-Li's going to be a stunner.
Paul said he's going to cosplay E Honda next time he gets a chance to come to Revival.
Good idea.
He did a good Kingy pile, so.
Yeah.
Got to be done, Paul, man. Got to be done.
Is he coming next week?
Nah, he's a bit tight around Christmas and all that. He'll be back then for one of the next ones, I'm sure.
Jesus.
Oh, look at that! Oh, vitality, like, fuck all!
Mike really needs this, man.
Yeah, this is all I'm missing it.
You do realise the head stomp will just fucking batter that every time.
I don't have to do that either.
Yeah, 2 seconds off the kick.
Grab. Oh, yeah, grab advantage then as well. Grab. Oh, Danny, too.
I caught before you. So.
If he's on Champion Edition, he'd have won by now because he's so fucking cheap on Champion Edition.
So, how many games have you won today, Mike?
Zero. But I win it live because I'm here with all my friends.
Where?
You can all fuck off.
What challenge was we going to do today? You had a challenge in mind, didn't you?
Ghouls and Ghosts, yeah. Definitely.
Right, after this fight, then, we'll see if Mike can redeem himself at least once. Since I was picked Ryu, even though we said we weren't going to. And
I don't know if we're going to have time, so we need to fuck off in a bit.
Oh,
well,
do
well, go on, Emma.
And we'll have a quick Ghouls and Ghosts blast then, and I'll just keep this on the screen. And we'll do a challenge on there. Then what is it? Oh, you score. What do you want to do? Fastest level
completion. Fastest. 3 lives.
Alright.
You nutted the shit out of you. Why didn't the barrel break then? Of course.
You did win a game. You beat Tony when he had Sagat.
That's right.
He did.
Oh, this better for no reason.
Yeah, and now he's beating you with Balrog, which is saying a lot, really.
Pressure's off now.
That's it. Into the worms.
Look at that. Fucking perfect.
Prefect.
Prefect.
That was a perfect man.
You gave got his mojo back.
Yes,
it's
the pressure of the move, it's all come natural.
Camera's back on
there,
though.
Oh no,
I can't
seem
to work. I can't
feel
perfect.
Oh no!
Not
the fuck out of him! Look how much energy he fucking lose for that!
Oh.
Oh.
Dear. Oh dear.
Well, yeah, not bad. Not bad. Yeah, it's good Ghouls and Ghosts, so we'll put it on 60Hz as well.
You should do it on the original game if you want.
Eh? Have you got it? Oh, have you got it there?
Yeah.
Go on then. Chuck it in. Worries. If you think there's some kind of bias because of my overdrive.
In. Mintero conditioner.
We are going to get a chance set up for filming properly today, I think.
Depends on how long we do this.
Well, this was going to be for the filming, Morris.
What do we do for the filming? No, I don't know what the fuck you want to do. I'm just here for the lols.
We can set the... What do you want to do?
We ain't got time today, because we've got like about 45 minutes.
We've captured some good footage, though, so there's still some here usable, are there?
We'll sort out today and do it properly.
Yeah.
Go on, that's it, is that you have to beat? Are we going to put a stop?
Block on this slide, sorry about this.
Stop cock.
They want stopwatch.
Yeah, let's have a stop.
I'll get in on this fucker as well.
However many lives you've got.
What's the challenge then?
So, quickest time to beat the first boss.
Right.
Obviously, if nobody gets to the boss. It's whoever got the furthest on the most lives.
I thought you
should. Whoever got the furthest.
No, to one life.
I'm fucking doing one life, that's a bit risky.
One life?
No, man.
You get one life.
You get three lives, fuck that, even I have that confidence.
Alright, stop sign. I thought you were going to do one life. Damn, you're going to push it off. He's a duck!
I'm a duck!
To answer your question, Paul, it was Vega in the Japanese version.
You're called Zenga in America, or is Angie?
No idea.
Yeah, called Zenga or called Zenji.
It was,
Vega was Balrog, and then Bison was Vega.
I reckon you should have done this one life.
I'll be having a fucking second with
it. Yeah, I wish you might wish you had. I'm not going to be there. I'm going to be there.
I'm all right up to this point.
I won't get to the first boss then. I'm fucking completed. It will be fastest.
It's here when it gets a bit muddly. I can tell what there's no protesting from him. Watch how fast he fucking presses this thing. Run away!
Yeah, we've got to do it in one life.
1 minute 52 seconds.
1 minute 52. I'm going for a piss and a calm down.
I know.
So
he's
there's an hole in that chair, no, anyway, while he was you can be in charge of that.
Well, maybe, I'll
reset that. Yeah.
What was it, 1 minute 53?
Yeah.
Correct, the fucking button.
We're not pressing, tell me right. Let's press.
Go.
Now.
Reset the ball up.
One life!
No way, you know, I was watching you knock shit out of her. Don't have to fucking drown you.
I did say at the beginning though, you've got all three lives, so.
To beat you, you've got to do it on the first ring.
So you fucked it already.
Well, no, because you was causing distractions knocking shit out of her. I can't fucking turn left with this fucking controller.
Nothing wrong with the controller. solid three.
You're just heavy handed with your fucking ass. You're just wanking all the time.
Well, I was trying to level the playing field by putting on 60 hertz and using them controllers because the AI practiced with them.
Run away!
Look at that, man! Oh, no! You jammy bastard!
Man.
I thought your fight was...
No, no.
I've never actually seen that happen before.
You were away.
I thought you were doomed.
Old man Mac!
Speed running with an old man. Mate's good for my lord.
Don't put any pressure on, but we've got about 20 seconds.
Fuck me, that was close. How you got away with that?
We do the Pro Evo challenge.
I'm up for that. How did you get away with that?
I cannot concentrate. I was screaming down in your roll. Right, I'll give up.
Okay.
Turn my game.
So that was a deep not finish. That was a do you can forever.
Do not fuck off.
You wanna go? Yeah.
It's on Newtown.
What's the jump and go?
C's jump, B's
start
attack.
Start trying to turn left because it's fucking.
Tell you what, I won't start the timer until you've jumped and shot. At the beginning, yeah?
Oh, so he's being charitable now.
You're allowed to move forward, you can jump and shoot, now start.
You'll be alright, I'll just go free. You'll be alright.
Go.
So that's a spirit.
There you go.
Well, that's not yours, it's in about 10 seconds in. You're being nice.
Cheers, mate.
I'll start for you when you get to the boss. At least you know you can pull off that tree manoeuvre. Oh, I
mean, cause of death.
It's hard to turn, isn't it?
Yeah, I've got lots of them. Oh, you bastard.
I had so many near misses on that though.
Oh, you.
When did you get your first extra weapon?
Depends. Well, there'll be none following you across the bridge. Feathers everywhere.
It's like a fucking Thanksgiving fucking massacre.
Oh, I love the duck after you went through your head.
Oh,
you tried to kiss him.
I thought it was it.
Every other chest is armour.
What was my time anyway, do you remember?
1.43.
What? Yeah.
Oh, what have I been freaking on now?
I don't know. You're always in the
episode, aren't you? Well, simply finish it.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's
a good
finish.
This game sucks ass, bro. I like you. I don't know why.
The sense of achievement of this, getting you around this game is fucking massive.
Is that revenge kill? You're stuck in like a rainstorm fucking limbo, yeah.
I bet his pants have sucked.
It catches there.
What? So what killed your arm? Was it the garbage
exposure?
Pneumonia.
I got my nappy wet.
Oh,
that one nearly went up the leg of shorts.
I think I went down for the last near misses. Like when I should have been dead.
Run, Forrest, run! He's got his skill on now, look at this!
Go on, you got loads of time, Tom.
I've got fucking no armour though.
Here it is. Go on. Go, go, go!
Ah.
Just go! You can do it! Drink!
Fucking
yeah.
Fair play!
Yeah.
Not bad!
No, that don't count though, because it was 3 lives.
Gives it a whirl.
That was
a pretty good one.
Right, you got one life.
I'll go and fucking get past the first few seconds of it, man.
I was looking at my phone, he's fucking.
To what?
Go on then. He's just doing what I do.
Yeah, he's doing the.
I don't know the land again. He's gone for the high road. He's gone the farthest with his armour.
Magnanimous in victory.
Look, watch. Fuck this pad. Yeah. Fuck this. This is our way. Fuck you. Get to the boss with his armor. Go. What was the time?
I got.
You died, didn't they? So it was 2:16 with the death.
You know what? I had played that.
That was really good. Yeah.
I had played that game forever, man. I'm quite happy with that, man.
I say I was quite
What do I win anyway? Do I win the game?
You can have it, it's time I'll game. Fucking Keith.
Did you say this the Nomad for
Fuck off! Fucking dream,
man. The Nomad was up there for grabbing.
So, anyway, guys, that was our stream for today. Sega boys, had a look at some Sega stuff. Interesting stuff, yeah?
Loved it.
Stuff, yeah.
Good stuff. And we'll be back with another stream pretty soon, guys. And we'll let Aaron go away and gloat and Mike go and cry.
Bastard!